Former President George Bush wouldn't miss this one. A sellout crowd of better than 58,000 here to see a critical matchup in the Big 12. Today it's the Red Raiders of Texas Tech against the Aggies of Texas A&M. And hi everybody, I'm Terry Gannon. Just 13 points have separated these two teams the past 3 years. Texas Tech on a three-game roll. And this is a critical matchup as we look at the Big 12 South standings right now. Texas A&M a perfect 3-0. Both Texas Tech and Texas with one loss. The winner of this game able to dictate things the rest of the way and decide their own future. They both have to play the Longhorns, Tim Brandt.
Two solid teams here. I mean, both have a lot of talent. If you look at A&M, they've got Sir Parker and Dante Hall. Of course, Tech has Ricky Williams, one of the best running backs in the entire country. But folks, make no mistake about it. These two clubs win with defense. And if you start with Tech, you have to go to their defensive end. Monte Rager, he is a big, strong, quick, talented guy. They turn him loose on that defensive end position. On the other side, you've got the best linebacker in the country, Dat Nguyen. This guy, folks, he is a heat-seeking missile, and I think these are the two difference makers in a ball game like this.
The Wrecking Crew and Swarm going head-to-head today in College Station. The Red Raiders and the Aggies get it on next.
Wade, he's tackled and he's fumbled the ball into the end zone. He has hit a touchdown, Texas A&M.
There's so many emotions that go through you. I mean, just excited, being happy, you know, just so many, to the point where it makes you cry.
Snap it, drop it back to the 32, dancing around, intercepted, Texas A&M.
And Cedric Curry picked off the ball, and it was kind of the greatest feeling I think I've ever been associated with in football.
A&M has won it. They have beaten the number two team in the country by a score of 28-21.
That was the last time A&M suited up here at Kyle Field. R.C. Slocum said after the game that it was his best win ever, the best emotions, the best feeling he's ever had after a game, and certainly Texas A&M got over the hump after the victory over Nebraska. You look at Chris Taylor back deep at his own goal line. Texas Tech won the toss and deferred to the second half. So Jared Griescher will get us underway here on a beautiful afternoon in College Station. For control of the Big 12 South. Taylor 5 yards deep, gonna bring it out. Cuts through, has a seam, breaks to the outside, tripped up. Oh, Chris Taylor had a chance to break it outside, but gets out to the 25-yard line. Oscar Solis may have saved a big return. The Chili starting lineups, the offensive line for Texas A&M. Cameron Spikes this year moved inside to guard because Rex Tucker is playing very well. Chris Cole, the deep threat, but they throw to the tight end often. Dan Campbell in there to start, but Derek Spiller will play a lot. And the back, Dante Hall, small but very elusive. And Jamar Toombs, the big load at 262 pounds.
They're going to try to bang Hall early, try to establish a running game. They also want to get McCown to pass a little bit early.
Leroy Hodge in motion. They're going to pass on first down. Plenty of time for McCown, but he's going to go down near the line of scrimmage. May have gained a yard, and the ball is loose.
He was looking for Dante Hall, and Hall was covered. So he tucked it away and just took it up himself. And Tech says they have the loose football.
They're still trying to sort things out. That's a rugby scrum, and the officials are a part of it.
Love all the politicking that goes on during a loose ball.
That ball may have changed hands 4 times since the original whistle, and Tech has the ball.
Oh, my.
The turnover to start the game. Spike Dykes thrilled with his defense, coming up with a huge play on the first play from scrimmage.
It was a little swing pattern that they were trying to get to Hall, but watch this. As soon as he'll look to the left side, right now, he sees Hall is covered. All right, so he's going to tuck it away and go, but he really doesn't tuck it away. Now it's there, but watch. Here's the hit. The ball's on the ground. You see it loose. Oh, my. There's the ball in there. Watch this. It comes loose early. See it on the ground? And the ball stays way over here. And it was Norman, John Norman, that came up with it.
That's only the 7th turnover all season long for the Aggies. That has been a big part of their success and a reason why they have won 6 in a row.
Tech with no huddle wants to go in a hurry. They'll do that all afternoon.
So Rob Peters, the quarterback, leads them at the 25-yard line. Huge opportunity for the Red Raiders. They give it to Ricky Williams. He is dumped right at the line of scrimmage. He may have lost a yard. And now we'll switch and give you the Chili starting lineups for Texas Tech, the offense. The biggest offensive line in all of college football. They're even bigger with Steve McFadden in there at tackle. Donnie Hart, the big play receiver, doesn't have blazing speed, but he knows how to play this game. And Ricky Williams, you know all about him, the number three rusher in the country.
Not only the biggest offensive line in college football, but there's not a bigger offensive line in the pros.
Second and 10. Peters to throw with a straight drop, plenty of time. Now looks to run, which he can do. Falls ahead for about a yard. Ronald Flemings, the defensive tackle, number 99, stopped him. And this is a small defensive front for Texas A&M. Rocky Bernard, the biggest guy at 269 pounds. Very good linebackers, though. Dat Nguyen, a Lombardi semifinalist, a Butkus semifinalist. Rich Cody, the former walk-on in a great story, leads the secondary.
Yeah, the linebackers are the engine which drives that Texas A&M train, and that's the guy right there, Dat Nguyen. He's the foreman of that wrecking crew.
Third and a long nine. They go very quickly. Peters goes down. The 30, the sack by Ron Edwards, number 96, the sophomore out of Houston. Big plays by the defense, and you talked about it in the open, Tim.
You know, I think Dat Nguyen was actually a spy that time on Peters. He stays back in his linebacker position, and they brought the pressure from outside. Once they brought him outside and flushed him in the middle, Ron Edwards, the middle guy down here on that defensive line, made the tackle.
Chris Burkholz on now for a try from 46 yards, and that is as long as he's kicked one this year. 8 out of 10 on the year. Plenty of distance and through the uprights. Burkholz with a 46-yarder. The sophomore from Temple, Texas, put Spike Dykes and the Red Raiders on the board first after the turnover. 3-0, Texas Tech. Greaser, his second kickoff in less than 3 minutes. Chris Taylor back to return once again at his own goal line. 3-0, Texas Tech after the turnover. Taylor at the goal line. Wrapped up this time at the 15. Better coverage by Texas Tech.
Terry, it was a turnover that really got Texas Tech on the board. When we talked to Spike Dykes earlier in the week, he said that's been a point of emphasis for him. If you look at this, all the way back to 93 until last year, Texas Tech was in the best in the country. You couldn't get anybody close to them at turnover margin. But this year, they've really struggled. As a matter of fact, if you look at what they're doing, they're in the minus situation and 80th in the country. So the situation has really become one that Spike Dykes wants to make the club aware of, to try to force turnovers. And so far in this game, they did, and it got them 3 points.
First and 10 at the 15, Dante Hall in motion to the near side. They give it to the huge fullback, Jamar Toombs, and you hear the Toombs call from this Kyle Field crowd. Ahead for about two, Chris Kasurik on the tackle. The defensive line for Texas Tech, Monte Rager, a Lombardi finalist as well, the all-time leader in sacks in Tech history. Ty Ardoin back after a back injury, along with Shipley, who is in the middle. And Oscar Solis getting a start at one cornerback spot, had a big game last week. Keith Cochran, a run support man at strong safety. And they snap the ball early. Randy McCown falls ahead. Chris Kasurik may have jumped and made contact with that offensive line. Flags all over the place. And that's what they call Hal Dowden and his crew working the game today in College Station. Spike Dykes, 12-year man, the dean of Big 12 coaches.
See, this is just early in the ball game here. This is a guy that's anxious, but you have to be disciplined. He wants to get across, and very wise move to snap the ball to McCown.
Seth McKinney, the center, only a redshirt freshman. His brother with the New Orleans Saints, and a guy who redshirted last year and has played very well this season. Kasurik made the mistake. So it's second and short. Give it to Toombs again. Closed quickly, but he fell ahead. He's got the first down. They'll move the chains. Jamar Toombs listed at 235 pounds. Don't believe it for a second. He goes about 262 pounds. And Tim, he was up about 270 before the start of the year.
Yeah, and he averages about 7 yards every time he touches it. If you look at these numbers, I mean, that's fairly impressive. So when you have guys like Hall and Sir Parker that are just kind of quick guys, darters, you know, then you come back with this, and it's the old hammer and chisel philosophy.
Toombs still learning how to block. He was a tailback in high school.
at about 235 pounds, just running all over people. Dante Hall looks for room, sidesteps one, and up to the 28-yard line. Jason Jones, number 90, along with Reagan Bounds, the former world goat roping champion.
Well, I tell you what, they move a lot of people on those runs, too. They brought Spikes and Tucker. They pulled both the guard and tackle. They brought him around like a counter tray to get him out in front of the ball carrier. They will power you.
Leroy Hodge and Chris Cole now the wideouts. Texas Tech's goal today to stop Dante Hall first. Here he comes over the left side looking for room. Not much at all. Back to the line of scrimmage before Kevin McCullough, the outside linebacker from Irving, Texas, closed quickly.
I'm going to tell you something, too. McCullough plays that thing inside out all the way. Now watch the top of your screen. They take it down first, the read, but here comes the defensive end. Get it out. All right, now here comes the collision. Now you're going to see McCullough, number five, make the tackle. He actually overran it just a bit, but he came from that linebacker position. It was being forced back in by the corner out there, Solis. So McCullough then came from that spot and made the tackle. It was nicely done. He just has to break down a little bit more.
Randy McCown just buried by Monte Rager as he pitched the football. Straight drop. Now flushed out. McCown runs. He can run, too. Tripped up, though. A nice play at the 34-yard line. Antoine Alexander, number 30, tripped up McCown before he could get to the first down marker, and it looked for a moment like he'd get there.
Well, they ran him out of there. It was good coverage by Alexander, but look at Monte Rager. He just runs right by the play. See, they take him outside. That's an outstanding job by 53 Tucker, and then Paul, by just kind of guiding him out there that way, letting him run himself out of the play. And then, of course, McCown just took it underneath.
Shane Leckler on, one of the best punters in the country. And back deep is John Norman at his own 24. Long count, low snap. Leckler gets it off. It's a good one. I'm not sure he got the two-yard cushion. They'll throw the flag as Norman comes out to the 34-yard line, and there's no way they gave him the two-yard cushion to catch that football.
No, that's a good call, too, because he knows he can't be hit until he does catch it. But Toya Jones was right there and just closed in on him. Watch Jones, number five here. See, he's got to be 2 yards away from him. He's not. As a matter of fact, he's trying to distract him by flying past his left shoulder.
R.C. talking to Toya right now about that.
I love R.C. there, though. He's a teacher, you know. He's trying to teach him.
Guy you'd love to play for. Aggies trying to regroup on the sidelines. 3-0 Texas Tech. 9:17 left in the first. Texas Tech at 6-1. 3-1 in the Big 12. This for control of the Big 12 South. They take over first and 10. Peters looks one way, looks back. He's got Derek Dorch. The catch and up close to a first down. He may have it across the 45 to the 46-yard line. Dorch, the sophomore, who had 6 catches for 66 yards a week ago against Colorado. That was a career high.
Brought him all the way across the field in motion, then just sent him in the flat. They took their wide outs, and they sent him down deep to clear out that area, and then brought him back underneath.
They did get the first down, so they moved the chains. Now Peters up to the line very quickly. And a quick count. Again, plenty of time. Throws on the run and throws low. He had Doris wide open at about the 47-yard line.
Texas Tech right now showing a great variety. They came out and they were trying to run Williams. The one pass they threw in the first series was incomplete. So here they come back. They show us motion on one play. They come back and they show trips on the other. Look at the tempo, though. They're trying to get A&M out of their regular defense and out of their rhythm by coming up very quickly out of the huddle.
Peters changes the play and then stumbles on the way back down again. At the 36-yard line, Cornelius Anthony, number 46, the sophomore who has played in the shadow of Dad Wynn, but he is going to be a great one.
Boy, second leading tackler, he came through like a rocket. They just leave him alone. Here he is right here. Just come bring him right home. Nobody even picked him up. Nobody saw him. They came out. They spread there. He came through the opening. It was a called blitz. Wide open for Cornelius Anthony.
7-yard loss, and it brings up 3rd and 17. Red Raiders go back to the huddle, and now we'll come up to the line of scrimmage. And the crowd on its feet. The pitch, Ricky Williams looking for a block, gets outside. Touchback up to midfield and knocked out of bounds.
He also wanted a face mask call, didn't get the call. But, I mean, he can scoot. You know, he's one of these guys, he's not going to bang you. He's not going to come up and try to put a shoulder on you, overpower you. He's going to try to outquick you. He's going to try to beat you to the corner, break containment, and do it with his speed.
So Spike Dykes' club stopped on third down. And it brings up fourth and five. It's a long five. Have to get past the 45-yard line, and so he'll obviously punt it away. Ryan Roberson going to kick it to Chris Taylor. Taylor at the 13. Cuts back. Up to the 26-yard line. And A&M will start their next series right there. And a reminder, ABC Sports
revealed that everything is up-tempo today. Everything's moving quickly. And I think Texas Tech has come in, and I don't know if they surprised A&M, but they certainly have them rushing.
Hodge in motion. Randy McCown, the junior who took over the starting quarterback position from Stewart, going deep hole through his hands. Had a step on Anthony Malbro. And he was gone if he reels that one in.
Well, I mean, this was just a sprint. All it was a post pattern. They didn't have anybody in the middle. They didn't have the safety in the deep secondary. And all of a sudden, he throws deep, and this ball really should have been caught. I mean, it was on his fingertips. He's got to make that catch. Usually, Chris Cole does. He's got 25 receptions.
So he gets a rest now on second and 10. Dante Hall looks for a hole, drives it ahead up to the 29. And let's go up to New York and check in with John Saunders. John, before Antoine Alexander put the hit on it. Taylor, the other receiver who has really come on. Cole has been there.
They ran the outside guy deep to take out the defender. Then they brought Taylor underneath on a quick out. Watch Rager again, though. Monte Rager's been trying to get some pressure. And, I mean, Tucker's been doing a nice job. They're funneling to the outside. He's getting help from Hall. We've seen that several times now. And he really, if he does get to McCown, he's getting there late. But that's one of the very first times he even touched him.
All-time leader in sacks in Texas Tech history. They'll run the option. McCown keeps it. Wrapped up at the 39-yard line. Cody Patton and Monte Rager in on the stop.
See Cody Patton make that tackle over McCown, and Patton is like 300 pounds and he's 6'6", and it was like he just engulfed McCown.
You know, you hate it when you lose 15 pounds and you're still 300.
Oh,
that makes it tough. But he actually lost some weight since last season. He had the ankle problems, the knee problems, and part of the reason because he was up about 315.
You ever see a grizzly stand up? I mean, that's what it's like. The ball carry disappears when he wraps him up.
Second and 8, McCown directing traffic. Taylor in motion. Dante Hall one way, then the other, and about a yard short of a first down. Good gain for Hall and good blocking. He had a hole up front before Dorian Pitts, the outside linebacker from Lubbock, Texas, made the hit.
Keep in mind, Dante Hall's had three straight 100-yard games. He is so dangerous in so many little ways. I mean, he can dip and dart. He can outrace you to containment. He's solid inside. He made a terrific cut that time back to the right against the grain and against the pursuit that got him close to that first down. Now sets up his team in a very good situation up here at the 45. Now they only need a yard for a first.
Third and a long one. Give it to Toombs. He's got the first down in the Tech territory and brought down at the 46-yard line. Darwin Brown at 170 pounds, taking on the 262, Jamar Toombs.
Hammer and chisel. I mean, you bring Hall, he picks it up, gets you within a yard of the first, then you come back here with Toombs, 265, and 28 just rambles, and he loves it when he gets into the secondary. He loves to go against his big guys. He just says, I wish I could get lower and go shoulder to shoulder with him.
Gain of 7 in the first down, and the offense for Texas A&M now getting in a little rhythm and getting it done on the ground, which is where they want to do it. Option, and now McCown the throw. He's got Taylor on the near sideline, one-on-one with Malbro, and broken up. But there is a flag on the play.
Yeah, that's a good call, too. He gave him a little hesitation stutter step. It's the option pass. And when he gives him the little stutter step, Marlboro bit on it, came behind, and actually just before the pass got there, his arm came out, and his right arm pushes him. Look at his right arm. I mean, he's shoving him right now as the ball comes. Contact was made way before the ball was there and before he turned his head. Looks like good coverage by Marbro, but he actually was banging and shoved him and got an advantage, got the leverage by the push. You can't do that, and the flag came out. Pass interference.
Got a good look at Taylor's speed because Marbro has great speed, one of the fastest men on this team. And he had him by a step at least. From a tailback in high school. First and 10 from the 32. First drive that A&M has been able to sustain. Tunes the foot, still on his feet. To the 15, Jamar Tunes, the freshman. A gain of 17 and a first down. Got a great block from the center, McKinney.
Watch Haymooley, the guard, big old number 62, pull. Stop it right there. He gave the key block and just opened up the hole. Go ahead and roll it down. He came, pulled right in front of him, gave him the little trap, and there was no linebacker there because Haymooley, who's 303 pounds, took him out of there.
Eighth play of the drive that has been mostly on the ground except for the interference call. Dante Hall sidesteps, look for the hole, but there's none there. And there's no secret, Jason Jones and this defense keying on Dante Hall. But the Aggies seem to have gone to Tunes quite a bit.
Well, the A&M offense makes no secret about the fact they like to run first. And then, of course, they'll throw timing patterns, and the quarterback likes to run the option. This is all RC's offense, and it's done a nice job doing that. And you see that they've been pretty good success defensively now, stopping teams in the red zone.
Second down, the option to pitch to Hall. Cuts back. Inside the 10, drives it to the 8. Kevin Curtis, the freshman out of Lubbock, hit Dante Hall, but he was driven back.
They're just powering football right now. They're not finessing anybody. Look at the jerseys just fire out. They come off the end. They know most of the pressure. 80% of the time is going to come from the outside defensive end. They bring him down hard off the corner, so they're doing that. They're sacrificing the quarterback and just getting it out and pitching to the backs, and they're finding the corners.
All 190 pounds, you think of him as a small back, but he hit Curtis and took him another 4 yards. McCown has paid the price. He's been hit on every one of those options, though. Short drop. He looks over the middle. Incomplete at the goal line. Chris Cole, the intended receiver, and arguing that he was held.
You know, the situation with McCown, you're saying he's being hit every play. But that's the option football. He's got to come down. He reads that defensive end. And if the defensive end or linebacker is going to come to him, then he pitches and the option works. So he knows he's going to take a hit. Either that or he's going to tuck it up and run with the ball. So him being knocked around is not a big deal.
And he's 6'1", 210, and used to getting hit. But the defensive tech stops the long drive of the Aggies. A try of 25 yards. You're going to fake it. The trick plays worked last week to the end zone. Touchdown. Don't tell anybody this offense is conservative. Dan Campbell with the catch from the Shane Leckler pass. The Aggies on the board after the trick play.
Well, I tell you what, too, they just fell asleep. Look, here's your tight end down the bottom of the left here. Just slipped past everybody. They thought he was just going to block. That play is not very difficult to defend against if, in fact, you're conscious of the fake.
Bynum's extra point is up, and it is good. They had three last week. Offense opening things up again. Spike Dyke's team held to fourth down, but then gave up the fourth down pass to the end zone. Hey. 7-3, the Aggies on top as Shane Leckler gets set to kick it away after he just threw a touchdown pass to the tight end Dan Campbell. John Norman at his own 4. Outside the 20 and wrapped up at the 24-yard line. Christian Rodriguez got there first to make the hit. There's Campbell, his first touchdown catch of the year.
Terry, Texas Tech now will come out, and we talked about them being up-tempo. They won't even spend much time on a huddle. They'll bring it out, and they'll try to keep the A&M defense on its heels. We've been seeing that the entire time. So what we're going to do is, as soon as they break the huddle, we'll start this snap clock, and you watch how quickly things happen.
Going to keep the defense on their heels so that they can't make any adjustments even more than 6 seconds. Derek Dorse to catch at the 35. Across the 40 and out to the 45-yard line on first down. They'll move the chains.
See, now they'll get back in the huddle, and when they break again, it's going to be the same situation. Watch and see if it isn't right in the 5, 6, 7 second range. They're not giving the A&M defense much time to make their calls, much time to call out the blitzes, much time to get in their coverages and that type of thing. I mean, they have just enough time to call out the strength formation.
Something that Dick Winder, who is a former coordinator here, now is back on the staff, has done throughout his career. A little more than 7 seconds. Williams ahead for one.
And we'll do it one more time and show you again. They'll stay right in that 5, 6, 7 second range. Now, A&M's doing a nice job by getting out of the huddle quickly, because you've seen some teams, as we watched film against Texas Tech, Baylor was still breaking the huddle while the play was actually starting. Texas Tech gets out. They make you hurry up on what you're doing.
Can react to
here
the
they go.
Personnel on the field, but it's hard to react to the formation and the motion. Less than six. Peters throws to the flats through the hands. Derek Dorse tried. Actually, Donnie Hart was out there, tried to make a diving catch, couldn't do it.
So you get an idea what Spike Dykes tries to do with his offense. He calls the play, and then he gets him to go. Now they'll take more time, but you know, Dorse is having a nice ball game. You know, he's been open a couple of times. Hart's been having a nice job. He's been open a couple of times. That a good pass right there, and that's completion.
And Dorse had a couple of catches and was open another time, and Peters underthrew him. Well, it's third down. Third and 10. Straight drop. Peters throws behind Hart, who had Jennings all over him.
But I think a good pass there, and he's got another completion
and may have a touchdown. Actually, Hart was ahead of Jennings. There was no one behind it,
but there was pressure. In all fairness, you watch this now. Peters doesn't have a lot of time to set. It's a five-step drop, and he tries to release it. See, but Dett Wynn's coming up the middle. He also has some help there from Anthony, and so he's got to release it a little bit before he wanted to, but Hart actually had a step.
Taylor back deep. Ryan Roberson, the junior, ball's on the ground. He gets it away. Taylor's going to let this one bounce. It goes out of bounds at the 22-yard line. A punt of 33 yards, not the effort Roberson wanted. Well, tomorrow right here on ABC Sports Live at 3:30 Eastern time, MLS Cup 98 from Pasadena to Rose Bowl. Major League Soccer season coming to an end. Two-time defending MLS Cup champion D.C. United taking on the Chicago Fire. They'll miss the final moments of the season on ABC.
DC United going for its third straight win. Short week, though. They had the game against the Crew to decide the Eastern Conference Championship on Wednesday night, so it's a short week for them.
And put the snap clock in now for Texas A&M and see the difference. Tech was about 5, 6 seconds. A little more than 12 seconds. Dante Hall darts straight ahead to the 32, close to a first down, but a yard shy.
Yeah, but in all fairness, Texas A&M is more of a come out, be deliberate. Their running game is what they want to set up. There's no hurry, and they like to shorten the game. They want to shorten the game as much as they can against all their opponents. We saw it against Nebraska, and they're going to do it here against Tech today. So there's no hurry once they break the huddle, and they will probably take twice as much time to get a playoff once the huddle is broken.
It shows you the difference in approach of R.C. Slocum and Spike Dykes. Inside give, Toombs. Here's his name, chanted again. He's got a first down. Drives the pile close to the 35-yard line. And 27 seconds left in the first. It's been a fast-moving first quarter.
Really has been. It's been a strange first quarter, and neither team, I don't think, really has found its rhythm yet. We haven't seen Sir Parker, number 8, when he comes into the game for A&M. You have to be focused on him as a runner, as a receiver, even a passer, but he hasn't been in yet. It's all been Hall and the wideouts.
Chris Taylor in motion, going to come back. They fake the reverse. Hall jumps over one, gets out to the 35, a gain of one after all of that.
Well, you know, here's a situation where A&M knows that they've watched films, and of course it was Taylor that took that reverse last week for the big gainer.
Defense is playing well. The trick play to the end zone for Texas A&M, and it's the Aggies with a 7-3 lead after one. Kyle Field, Terry Gannon, Tim Brandt. Temperatures in the mid-70s. Not a cloud in the sky. 7-3 Aggies. Boy, it is hard to beat the atmosphere here. One of the most electric venues in all of college football. Second and 9 to open up the second quarter for the Aggies. Give it to Dante Hall. Cuts back, drives up to the 39. Got to get to the 44-yard line for a first down.
Yeah, it'll bring up a passing down, Terry, but I mean to tell you, the offensive line for A&M is doing a nice job. I mean, they've been running some counter traps, counter trays. They've been moving the inside guys, Emuli and Spikes, and they move around a lot. And they're doing a good job opening up holes for Hall. Now, he hadn't had the big gainer yet, but he's getting the yardage at 4 and 5 a clip right now. And if you keep doing that and banging down the defense, eventually you're going to break one.
Texas Tech has been great against the run. There's the average per rush today, 3.5 for the Aggies. Tech great against the run. Your ball is down. Now up, Monte Rager, I believe, came up with it. McCown never had it. Rager, another big play, and he's had plenty throughout his career in this season.
Boy, we talked about Rager at the beginning of the game. Watch the right hand of your screen because the ball's loose. There's 34. He's got his eyes on it the entire time and goes up and gets it. He's one of the most dominant defensive players in the Big 12. They use him outside, they use him inside, and his awareness right there, almost like a back or a wide receiver. Once he located the ball, he stayed with it and brought it in. Great play by Monte Rager, the defensive end.
Second big turnover now for the Aggies, so Texas Tech got a field goal after the first one. They'll try to get more here. First down, Derek Doris scoots through close to a first down. We'll see where they mark it. That's the third catch already this afternoon for Doris.
And I suspect we'll see him going back to Doris, going back to Hart a lot. We've talked about both guys finding the open spaces, being able to separate from the A&M defensive backs. If they do that, Peters is going to find them. And right now they're having great success with their passing game. Really, Ricky Williams has been fairly quiet running the ball.
Both Donnie Hart and Derek Doris, they don't have blazing speed. They're not going to run by people very often, but they know how to find the seams in the defense and come up with a big catch. Second down, plenty of time, plenty of room for Peters. Got a first down and more to the far sideline and knocked out at the 11. Brandon Jennings, the safety, knocked him out there, but a huge gain for Rob Peters.
Terry, and again, it's the passing game that set up the big scramble for Peters. Boy, he sent Jackson out one side. He sends Dees out the other side. All of a sudden, watch everything open up in the middle. He's got great protection, but he sees the crease, and once he tucks it away, the only guy really has to beat is 30 Jennings. The safety comes over and saves a touchdown, runs him out of bounds. You see Anthony chasing him. He's not going to get there. It was Jennings' pursuit angle that saved the touchdown.
Peters at 6-2-29, the second leading rusher on the team. Here comes the leading rusher, Ricky Williams, to the end zone, touchdown. Touchdown number 11 on the season for Ricky Williams on the grab. And again, the Red Raiders take advantage of a turnover by the Aggies.
Pass, scramble, and then run. And what a block by 94 Allman. Watch your tight end open this thing up to the right of your screen. Look, just carrying players out there. And he was untouched. Great blocking by McFadden and Caruth, but it was Allman on the outside that made the block to set him free.
Williams got the touchdown, but you may have been able to run that one in with the hole that he had. 9-7 awaiting the extra point. Up and good. Burkholz straight on through. Ricky Williams, another touchdown. Taking it in, and it is 10-7. Texas Tech on the road. In the country, touchdown number 11, and he took it from 11 yards out. It is 10-7 Texas Tech. Turnovers have been the key for them so far. This is a short kick, handled and then fumbled. The ball is loose, but Chris Taylor, the deep man, came up with it at the 13-yard line.
A&M looks very shaky today. And defensively, one of the adjustments they're going to have to make is to change what Datwin's doing. He's getting cut off. First, he gets it here by 79 Gray. Gray is 357 pounds. Then he gets bowled over. Lowry throws a block, and it kind of bowls him back into Datwin as well, and he goes off his feet. Datwin is very quiet today. We haven't called his name very much, and they have to make adjustments to get him up into the mess before he's getting cut off by the big lineman.
When the house hits you, even if you're Datwin, you go a ways. First down for the Aggies. Dante Hall trying to get outside. Looks for room. Back up. Driven out at the 17-yard line. Let's check in once again with John Saunders in New York.
Terry, UCLA stumbled out of the gate against Cal today, but boy, have they recovered. Cade McNown, 35 yards to Brian Pauley-Dixon, his second touchdown reception of the day. And they're up just like that, 14-7. Terry.
All right, John, so the Bruins have come back in that game after a slow start. Here it's 10-7. Texas Tech off of two turnovers by A&M.
And John made the point about UCLA stumbling out of the blocks. I think Texas A&M is stumbling out of the blocks. They put the ball on the ground a couple of times. They really haven't been sharp, and now Dante Hall is down, and they're working on him. So it's their number one running back who's had three straight 100-yard games. He's banged up a little bit, and if he can't play, you know, they're going to be a little bit shaky back there because Sir Parker is his backup. He's the fastest guy on A&M's program, but he's got a bad ankle, and he has not been 100% the last couple of days.
Got 35 yards on the day off. 10 rushes already for Dante Hall. We've got Eric Bernard, who's a sophomore, out with a torn ACL.
Yeah, Rhodes would be the next guy, and he's relatively inexperienced.
Well, it's time now for the Aflac trivia question. Now, here it is. Timmy and I have worked on this all week. Can you explain these scores in relation to who will win the Big 12 South? Florida State beat A&M 23-14 first game. Then NC State over Florida State 24-7.
Yeah, but after that, look, NC State comes and gets upset by Baylor. And then Texas A&M beats Baylor, so you go back to say, wait a minute, NC State should have beaten Baylor, but they beat Florida State, and A&M lost to Florida State. How do you figure it?
We have worked on that all week, so that is your Aflac trivia question. That is your assignment. Dante Hall up and walking off, which is a good sign. Well, it brings up second down. Second and seven. From the 17-yard line. It is Vernest Rhodes, the sophomore, who is in right now, so Sir Parker doesn't come into the game. He's got the hamstring pull. Rhodes over the left side. Close to a first down on it. Believe he has it up at the 24, maybe the 25, before Kevin McCullough, the outside linebacker, stopped him.
All right, we say he's relatively inexperienced, so that's a good start for him. Rhodes gets some good blocking up here, but watch, he does a lot of this on his own. He's got good, quick feet. Look, he finds the hole, finds the crease. Now he explodes through there, and he'll pick up some extra yardage. So when you come out like that, that helps build your confidence a little bit. Look at him. He's excited to be in the ball game. He's excited to get out of the blocks with a good play.
Played well last year, but he had a back injury, and he missed the last six games of the season.
Hall should be back, though, Terry. He's got a stinger, and that'll go away. Once they get those pins and needles out of his arm, he'll be back.
For the slimmest of margins, they'll move the chains.
Talking about A&M stumbling out of the blocks. I'll show you what we mean. I mean, this has not been a good start for them. I mean, the series starts out, and you have a couple of plays that work, but you put the ball on the ground. So the first possession is a fumble with the fake field goal, and they get a touchdown, but then they fumble again. So you can't put the ball on the ground and expect to really have that successful day that you had worked for all week.
Tulane with big numbers on the board, having a great season. Jimmy Bowden, brother, of course, stepping down as the head coach at Auburn. McCown with time, got Cole over the middle, knocked away.
Well, what a great play by Solis. I mean, that is as good as it gets. He had him completely covered, then read the ball, became the receiver, and knocked it away. Guy looked like Darryl Green on that play.
Fastest man in the NFL. Well, tonight, primetime coverage. 8 o'clock Eastern, 7 Central here on ABC. The U.S. Pro Figure Skating Classic from San Jose, California. The conclusion of the men's competition. Todd Eldridge, the 5-time U.S. champion. Reigning Olympic champion Ilya Kulik will be there. 8 o'clock Eastern, 7 Central. Second down. Rhodes, tough running over the right side across the 30 up to the 33-yard line. Got to get to the 34 just outside of that for a first down. Ty Arduan, the senior out of Beaumont, Texas, in on the stop.
Texas A&M getting back to what it does best, running the football and running it hard behind the big offensive lineman. The offense has done a nice job all year protecting the ball, only two interceptions. Now they put it on the ground twice in the first quarter of this game. They cannot let that affect them. They have to go right back to the basics, and that's what they seem to be doing in this drive.
Third and almost two. Give it to Rhodes again. Pulls his way across the 40. And the sophomore gets to the 41. A nice block again by McKinney. And they, again, Timmy, you just mentioned it, opening up holes for the running backs. Nothing fancy.
Well, and this is not a small offensive line. I mean, this offensive line weighs 299 pounds. They average that. So this time they slant him down, and he cuts back behind the slant right off their butt, picks up a nice hole. Look at Rager. Rager's been struggling all day. Tucker's been just dominating him. He's getting into him. He's getting his hands on him. He's 290 pounds. Rager's just 270, and so far he's controlled it.
Came up with the big fumble recovery, though, that led to the touchdown. Rhodes trying to get outside. Turns it back. Nowhere to go. He lost a yard at the 40. McCullough was there to wrap him up. That was Reagan Bounds.
McCullough's playing a nice game, too. 6'3", 245-pound linebacker. He's been running all over the field. We saw him make three tackles in the first quarter. He comes out here in the second quarter. He starts with a nice tackle there, chasing guys down and making the hit.
He's had a bad ankle. Injuries throughout his career, really. Had a knee injury last season. As you look at Dante Hall strapping it on, trying to loosen up that stinger. Should be back. Rhodes running well over the right side, had a hole, but it closed quickly at the 47-yard line. A gain of five. Arduan on the stop again with Kevin Curtis. Curtis, a true freshman from Lubbock.
Now Rhodes comes out of the ball game, and they bring Taylor in. As soon as Taylor comes in again, got to be conscious of the reverse, got to be conscious of the pass.
Taylor had an 81-yard touchdown catch against Nebraska and a 61-yard reverse for a touchdown against Baylor. Third and five out of the shotgun. McCown overthrows his tight end. Derek Spiller was open and had a first down if he makes the catch, but McCown threw it well over his head.
Yeah, and Chris Taylor, who brought the play in, the guy we were just talking about, was wide open too. He slapped his helmet. He says, McCown's not looking at me. Instead, he tried to go inside. He had the completion there for brings the ball back because Spiller's a big target at 6'3". But out on the outside, to the left of that was Taylor, and there wasn't anybody around him.
Shane Leckler, who averages well over 45 yards a punt, will kick it away to John Norman, who is at his own 10-yard line. Low snap just does get it away, though. Some contact, no flag. Norman with the fair catch at the 17-yard line. So that's where the Red Raiders will start. 37 yards on the punt, not a normal Leckler effort. 10-7 A&M.
You guys are in here again? I can't believe this. You're always in here nursing your injuries. I have never seen such a group of cream pops in my life. This is football. I need guys that can play.
Man, I thought he'd never leave.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Hot dog, anyone?
People smile and tell me I'm the lucky one. And we've just begun. Think I'm gonna have a son. And in the morning when I rise, you bring a tear of joy to my eyes and tell me everything's gonna be alright.
Aflac, insuring over 40 million people worldwide.
There is no limit to where it can take you. A leather-trimmed and preferred suede interior, heated front seats, and dual zone temperature control. Winner of the Total Quality Award for Best Ownership Experience. The most luxurious minivan you can buy. Chrysler Town & Country. We call it limited. You'll call it unlimited. Chrysler, engineered to be great cars. Now, get a 1,000 cash allowance on Chrysler Town and Country.
Reveille not happy about the way things have gone so far. 3-point lead for Texas Tech over Texas A&M here in College Station.
If you're on defense, you've got to be conscious of the fact that Ricky Williams has only touched the ball 4 times, and here he comes.
On first down, wrapped up right at the line of scrimmage at the 17-yard line. Nowhere to run. Well, Sunday night, live at 8:15 Eastern on ESPN. Sunday Night Football. Doug Flutie getting another start for the Buffalo Bills. First one worked out well. They take on the Carolina Panthers. Then Monday Night Football on ABC. An AFC showdown, always a good one. The Steelers with Cordell taking on the Chiefs at Arrowhead. 23 yards for Ricky Williams. Doris in motion. Peters wants to keep it. Nowhere to run again. Well defense by this Wrecking Crew defense. Warrick Holman made the hit, but they made sure they stayed with Ricky Williams as well.
You know, Holman could be A&M's most disruptive defender. Everybody talks about that win, and certainly Anthony gets all his tackles. He's the second leading tackle. But 43, Holman is all over there as well. He's the third leading tackler, and he makes a lot of big plays.
That leads him in sacks. He's got 6 on the year. Tackles for loss, 11 behind the line of scrimmage. And right now, Tech has controlled that win for much of this game.
Well, people compare Holman to Reggie Brown. You're right.
Peters throws to Donnie Hart out of bounds. Incomplete. And the A&M defense now getting this crowd up and into the ballgame.
And you could feel that A&M was in more of a rhythm there.
Yeah.
They didn't seem as discombobulated as they had earlier, getting used to the up-tempo offense. They've made some adjustments now. They seem to have things down and timed.
Don't lead those way when they snap the ball.
The loss in the first game of the year to Florida State. A&M has won 6 in a row.
It's a big punt here, Terry, because A&M's going to get good field position.
Line drive kick. Chris Taylor at the 47-yard line. Cuts back. Has some room if he can turn it outside. 30. The 27-yard line. Chris Taylor with a return that will set up great field position.
Yeah, I was just going to say, forget the good field position. They're in spectacular field position.
Well, ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Chrysler, engineered to be great cars. Bud Light, for the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light. State Farm Insurance, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And the document company, Xerox. Keep the conversation going. Share the knowledge.
Terry, you start your offense at the 26-yard line, and it's like chum to a shark. They're going to go into a feeding frenzy. They may try to score right away.
Long count from McCown. Gives it to Rhodes off the right side. They didn't try for the big play on first down. To about the 24, Ty Ardoin made the hit on the sophomore. So Dante Hall not back in the game. Ernest Rhodes carrying the load right now. Game 2 on first down. 7:55 and counting until halftime. The double tight end set, which A&M uses often. Both Campbell and Spiller in for R.C. Slocum. Count on the roll under pressure, throws, and this one's picked off. He was going for his tight end Campbell, who's already had a touchdown catch, but John Norman comes up with the pick.
Terry, that's only the third interception this year, and again, they just seem to be turning the ball over and giving Texas Tech way too many chances.
Norman with his first interception of the year, the third critical turnover for A&M in the ballgame. Wow.
You believe this?
Wow. 3 huge plays. Hard to believe, especially with the
really
way they've
is.
Controlled the ball this season. Quick out, incomplete. Jonathan Hawkins, the man who was wide open.
I mean, we're looking at each other saying, do you believe this? Because A&M is a club which really has not turned the ball over much this year. And now they fumbled twice. They've thrown the interception. They still lead, but Texas Tech just will not go away. Texas Tech now with the 10-7 lead, but I mean, you know, you think that they're in control of this ball game. They certainly give you that feeling that it's more than a 10-7 game.
The loudest it's been since the opening kickoff. Incomplete. D. Jackson was well covered at the 30-yard line. Rich Cody, the former walk-on, one of the men who surrounded him. Rich Cody, a great story, too. You know about him, the senior from Dallas, the former walk-on, and now has started 33 consecutive games and led the secondary for 3 years, including this one, in tackles. The ball at the 12-yard line, so a critical 3rd and 10 coming up for Texas Tech. They don't want to have to punt out of their own end zone. Straight drop for Peters. Here comes that win. Down at the 3. The ball was loose, but he was already down, and that's the first big play of the game for Wynn.
He makes the big play straight up the middle again. They pull one guy. He comes untouched. You don't want to leave your All-American untouched. How can you, if you're Texas Tech, leave that win alone and not put somebody on him? This guy is the All-American. He is the engine that drives this train, and nobody picked him up. Nobody saw him, and he made your quarterback pay.
Averages better than 10 tackles a game. Got the best numbers out of anybody on the Butkus list right now. He's one of the semifinalists.
Rob Peters almost lost the ball.
Roberson gets it away. Taylor at the 41 of Tech. Still dancing. Cuts back straight ahead to the 27-yard line. Well, great field position again for the Aggies, but it meant nothing a moment ago. They threw the interception. They'll try it again.
May I help you?
If I wanted a Whopper, no pickles, that wouldn't be a problem. But would we get to hear you sing?
No, sir. You get to hear us sing.
Hold the pickle, hold the lettuce, special order, don't
May I help you?
If I want my value meal with rings
instead of fries,
is that a problem?
Value meal with rings or fries, it still costs the same great price. You don't have to ask us twice to have it your way.
When you have it your way, it just tastes better.
Because of our passion for design and engineering, our vehicles speak for themselves. And recently, others have had some great things to say about our quality, too. Sebring Convertible, Total Quality Award. Town & Country, Total Quality Award. Cirrus, Best in Class in Initial Quality by J.D. Power & Associates. Concord, Best in Class in Initial Quality by J.D. Power & Associates. Chrysler, engineered to be great cars.
If you are looking for tradition, if you are looking for success, if you are looking for a place where you are a member of the family, you are looking for Texas Tech. Texas Tech University, the largest research university in West Texas, the University of Champions, a place to excel and succeed. Come join us. Texas Tech University, the home of champions.
Promotional consideration provided by National Car Rental, the official car rental company of the Bowl Championship Series on ABC.
Let's go!
He was quiet most of the game, but came up with a huge play. That win with the sack. Now great field position for Texas A&M.
So he's done his job. Now it's up to McCown, who's been struggling.
McCown 1 for 6, 2 fumbles, and an interception. Not the numbers you want to see from any quarterback who's out there leading the way, but he keeps it this time. Good yardage over the right side to the 22-yard line. Next Saturday, live at 3:30 Eastern, right here on ABC Sports. Regional college football action. Texas takes on number 7 Nebraska. That'll be a big one in this area of the country, the Big 12 action. Rest of your lineup. Make sure you check with your cable or satellite company for those available on pay-per-view next Saturday. A gain of 6. Dante Hall back in the game, by the way, after the stinger. But he goes down. Monte Rager. What a matchup that is. And the quickness of Rager Much better than Hall that time. He was there as soon as he got the football.
They like to put him outside in what they call the nine technique, and he uses his quickness to avoid blocks. He is so quick. He's got such great feet and great balance. Not only can he dodge the blocker, but he gets into the backfield with balance and power when he makes the tackle.
Gained about 20 pounds in the offseason of muscle, but now is back down to about 250 pounds. That's what he was at last year. Huge backfield now. Toombs in there. Looked like Tech was offside when the ball was snapped. Flags on the play. Replay should be from McCown down to the 20. Devin Lemons, the sophomore, jumped offside.
And what you said is very smart. It is a free play, and Texas A&M knew that and tried to go ahead and run it. See, some teams kind of stop and hesitate, and they can't do that. It is a free
offside
play.
On the defense, 5-yard penalty. Repeat third down.
They saw R.C. Slocum a moment ago, and now Spike Dykes. Two coaches, Tim, we spent time around them. If you're a kid, it'd be hard to find any fault. You'd love to play for these guys.
And they're both very, very good friends. Yeah. Great respect for each other.
Texans, R.C., very proud of the state of Texas.
I'm big fans of both of these guys, and they do know how to coach.
Winningest coach in A&M history. And he loves the leadership of McCown that he has given him. Ball was loose for a moment, but it is whistled dead. Dante Hall on the carry, and he may be shaken up again.
Kazarek made a terrific hit on him. They pulled the guard on that side, and Kazarek actually came down without being blocked. Watch number 76 White come down and make this tackle. Boom! Right there. Now that is a huge guy. Kazarek's 290 pounds, and again, Hall's under 200 pounds. That'll shake you loose. That'll not only shake the ball loose, but it will rattle your fillings.
Russell Bynum on now for a try from 37 yards. Line drive kick and no good.
They're just not hitting on all cylinders right now. Texas A&M is just not all there.
Spike likes it, but a groan from the crowd here at Kyle Field. Well, we asked you earlier our Aflac trivia question. I hope you've been working on it since we asked you. Can you explain these scores in relation to who will win the Big 12 South? Give it another thought. We'll watch a play here and then give you the answer.
Yeah, how many times do fans go through this? Hey, look, Florida State beat Texas A&M, but then Florida State loses to NC State. Go figure. Then Baylor beats NC State, but, of course, A&M beat Baylor.
There is an answer. Trust me on this one. Tim and I don't know it, and we've worked on it for a week. On first down, Ricky Williams on the counter. Tripped up and out to the 24. Okay, here's the answer to the Aflac trivia question.
Those four games give us these four equations right here along with their point differentials. If we pick up a least squares solution to that system, then we pick up these values right here. We throw out Florida State and NC State because they're not in the Big 12. We add the A&M and Baylor values and pick up negative 12 fourths. Peel off the numerator and denominator, get the values 4 and 12. They tell us everything. Four games after A&M beats Tech, they win the Big 12 South.
Yeah, see, now I've got it.
Of course.
That makes sense.
You know, I got all the way up to that point where you throw out Florida State and NC State. I didn't throw them out of the mix. That would be a mistake.
Well, my problem was I didn't give it those values.
The modern Pythagorean theory at work, or something like it. Royland Bradley on the stop as Ricky Williams carries it. It'll bring up third and four.
See, this is the difference in the ball game. Texas Tech capitalizes every time it gets good field position, where A&M has had the best field position here in the first half and has not been able to capitalize.
By the way, our producer Mark Loomis responsible for the Aflac trivia question this
week. Well, that's because he went to Vanderbilt. You know, he was one of those brainiacs.
Yeah.
A mathlete. That's what we call him, a mathlete.
I won't follow that one up. Sack at the 21-yard line. Peters goes down. Royland Bradley, who just made a big play a moment ago, the sophomore in the backfield, and a loss of five.
You know, the story of this ball game so far is the A&M offense has not been able to help the defense, and the defense is, in fact, doing its job. They continue to put pressure on. They continue to contain. They continue to bring guys up the middle. And now they're even getting a secondary involved. This is a good defensive segment here by the A&M Aggies.
And it's Texas A&M who calls the timeout now with 2 minutes and 11 seconds until half. Spike Dykes got to like what's on the scoreboard, but A&M with the mistakes and not able to take advantage of some things. You know, we asked R.C. Slocum about that, and he had some thoughts on the Aflac trivia question, too.
That's the story of college football, and it's something that the fans long wanted, and they got it with the parity. From week to week, you just don't know who's going to win the game, and I think that that's great for the fans, and it's going to make for a bunch of old, worn-out coaches.
I don't think his club's given away anything that it shouldn't have. They faced a very solid Florida State team early in the season. Then they came back, and everybody here is still talking about the big win over Nebraska. They were concerned the next week after Nebraska of a letdown, but they went and beat Baylor soundly. So I think he's very pleased with where he is and his club is. And, of course, they're ranked, eighth in the country in the AP and 10th in the USA ESPN coaches poll. So his team's right where it should be.
Jeremy Hernandez now with punt to Chris Taylor.
Wow.
Drives him all the way back to the 31. Taylor looks for room and nothing doing out to the 39-yard line. That's it. Kevin McCullough down there very quickly. A punt of 48 yards and a return of 11. Well, but RC makes the point that you can't really explain college football these days because of the parity, and any team really can beat another on a given day. It's a cliche, but it's true. You look at Temple and what they did a week ago to Virginia Tech. And RC said, so how much better does that make us than Florida State?
So many variables involved now. Recruiting's become so competitive, and they only have 15 to 20, 25 scholarships every year to give away now.
A&M with a huge advantage in total yards. And not on the scoreboard. McCown throws, gets hit. Dante Hall with a catch. Still up, inside the 30. Still on his feet. Hall down to the 5-yard line. Dante Hall with a great catch and then the yardage after it. First and goal after a 56-yard play.
First of all, McCown, under a lot of pressure, gets some key blocks, but there's pressure coming, and he still throws the ball off balance. Now, it was Hall that slipped out of the backfield by himself. Cockrum missed the tackle, and then all of a sudden he's picking up blockers downfield. Cole got one, but what great balance, what great feet by Hall. Terrific play by four different players on A&M to make that thing work.
First and goal, just outside the 5. Burness Rose now in at tailback. Give it to the fullback, Toombs fights his way, but may have lost a yard.
Before the ball's even snapped, they start here in the stands to yell, Toombs, Toombs. You know the defenders are looking for him as well.
Antoine Alexander hit him, the cornerback, and actually drove him back a yard. He was going east-west instead of north-south. But second and goal now outside of the 5-yard line. Call it from the 6. Toombs and Rhodes in the eye. Option right. McCown's going to keep it. Struggling down to the 2. Chris Kasurik.
Here they come again. There. Terry, they're starting to yell for Toombs again. Not a bad call down here by the 1-2. Give it to your guy that's 265 pounds. Let him just bang in there.
Big rumble, they call it. And A&M will burn another timeout. And while we have a moment, let's check in with John Saunders, Todd Blackledge, to see what's coming up in halftime.
Coming up on Valvoline Halftime 98, we will have scores and highlights. More on Terry Bowden's decision to leave Auburn and the BCS.
At a bowl championship series, we're moving closer. The standings come out for the first time Monday. We'll explain it all at halftime.
All right. It's all coming up on Valvoline Halftime 98.
All right, John and Todd. Yeah, the standings come out Monday. So we'll see for the first time the real list, the bowl championship series. Today's Marriott moment takes us back to 1995. The matchup between these two teams, 7-7 tie, 35 seconds left. A&M 3rd and 6 from the 18. You know who, Zach Thomas picks it off, goes all the way. Stopped the run of 5 consecutive. A&M wins over Tech. And Tech went on to win the last three in a row. It turned the tables. Three straight great games that have gone down to the wire in this series.
Boy, you think about some of the linebackers they've had as you look at the series record. Played all those 95 years, but I mean Zach Thomas and Marcus Coleman and Sean Banks, some outstanding linebackers.
Tech defense last week allowed the one touchdown and six times inside the red zone. Now third and goal from the one. Ball got there. Dante Hall with a 1 yard touchdown run before halftime. How crucial is that, the way A&M has struggled in this first half?
Well, I tell you what's emphatic is the way that they did it. They were very strong. They took it right down there and jammed it down the throats of Texas Tech, and Dante Hall capitalized. He's only the 12th Aggie to run for 2,000 yards in his career, and there was no question about the way he banged that one in there.
Bynum on for the point after. Up and good, but there is a flag on the play. Penalty marker down inside the five. Dante had the stinger earlier.
Dead ball, false start on the kicking team. Retry the try.
See, but even when they're successful, even when they score the touchdown, they're still not there. They're still not in sync. I can't remember A&M making as many mistakes as they have here in the first half.
And RC was really pleased last week after the huge win against Nebraska that there wasn't a letdown. As you mentioned, against Baylor, and they played very well. Scored 35 points. And had 535 yards in the game.
And it's not like there aren't a lot of guys playing a great game for A&M, because there are, but they're just, you know, making little mistakes here and there that are taking them away from the success they're used to.
Had to do it again, but Bynum up and through.
You so need a hard hat to go get that ball.
The Wrecking Crew in the end zone, too. Step away very quickly for a word from the NCAA.
It would have been easy to have been a football player and not a student. And conversely, it would have been much easier to have been just a student and left football for some other day and time. But it wouldn't have been as joyous, as rich, as humbling to have been one without the other. So for all of us, I say thank you from the bottom of my heart, not for a single award on a single night, but for the many memorable and molding moments that we have had the privilege to call ourselves student athletes.
Spike Dykes has seen his club play very well in the first half and really control much of the game with all the mistakes by A&M, but they trail 14-10.
Terry, we're just talking about you needed a hard hat to go get the ball. This is the construction at the end zone, and this is going to be a phenomenal football building, and they're going to have stands, triple-decker stands like they do on both sides. This will eventually hold more than 80,000 people, and you see more and more schools going to these big football buildings right there in the stadium and making it a complete facility. You need that to recruit successfully.
This has always been one of the great places to play, though, and watch a game. John Norman bringing it back for Texas Tech. Got a hole outside the 30, brought down by Toya Jones. Strong arm tackle at the 33-yard line. Good return for Norman, though. He's got 39 seconds now to work with for Texas Tech. They trail by four.
I think Tech is going to be fairly conservative here. See if they don't involve Ricky Williams right away, and then if they get out near the 40 and they start to open things up a little bit more. But you know, it's been a pretty good first half for them. They don't want to jeopardize that right now, and at the same time don't want to get too conservative. You just want to do what you do best.
Donnie Hart, the wideout, has been kind of quiet so far. Haven't been able to get him the ball. They set up the screen.
Tried to get it to Williams that way.
No chance for Ricky to catch it. Bring up second and 10. Peters now 3 out of 10 for 41 yards. Missed the two games, had the shoulder problem and the thumb problem, came back to run the offense well, but today not having a great day. Three receivers to the near side. Now Doris goes in motion to the far on second and 10. Quick drop, throws over the middle, almost picked off. Near midfield, the receiver really wasn't looking for the ball. Tim Baker, the intended, but Brandon Jennings had the best shot at making the catch.
Terry, it really surprised me. He threw into coverage. You don't want to jeopardize anything. You don't want to give them a shot. They make an interception here. They could put three more on the board in a heartbeat.
And 31 seconds left, so it's third and 10. And if you throw a pass here, it's incomplete. A&M's going to get a shot.
Sure, and you would not think that the ball game's going to be won or lost right here in the last 31 seconds, but they're anxious to give it back.
Yeah, they'll keep it on the ground. Ricky Williams, he's got a first down. That's a key first down.
I thought that's what they should have done on first down.
Out to the 46. They ran the draw with the four wideouts in.
And this is what we were talking about. You get it to Williams, he gets you out to midfield, and all of a sudden, see, now an interception here won't hurt you. It doesn't mean 3 points.
As long as you throw it downfield.
Sure, right. Now you can throw it.
Peters looking to throw, tucks it, going to run. No, he's going to throw. Got Baker knocked out of bounds at the 47-yard line. Cedric Curry on the coverage and the tackle.
Still have 11 seconds to work. That's two plays. So if you can get it down and get another pass here, you might have a shot at a field goal.
Again, trips to the near side. And that's where Rob Peters is looking. Got a world of time now inside the 40 to the 37 with 3 seconds left. And they'll call the timeout. Got a timeout very quickly as soon as Peters went down. And you can take a shot in the end zone.
Yeah, absolutely. I was surprised that they wasted those two plays early in this drive, which cost them a little bit of time, but certainly field position. Gonna try like, what if this would be a 55-yard field goal?
Yeah, they're gonna try actually place it down.
And so defensively, you better be looking for the fake. And then if you try it, it's gonna be an awfully long field goal.
Spike Dykes 5-6 against Texas A&M. He's had success. All five wins, by the way, after losses the week before. Spike got a contract extension through 2000. Longtime high school coach. This is Jarrett Greaser now, who comes on. He's been injured. Got injured last year, if you remember, against Nebraska. He's been injured this year, but he comes on as the long field goal kicker.
55-yard attempt.
And the first half ends. Spike taking a try from 55 yards. Little bit against the wind, though. 14-10. Texas A&M coming back after early turnovers. Valvoline halftime 98 comes up next.
It's been out of sync. Now, first, McCown here early never turns the ball over, but look at him here. Trying to make a play, tries to scramble, puts it on the ground. Now, here we go again. Look at Rager. Rager finds the ball up on somebody's shoulder pad, bounces around, he has one. And then, of course, two interceptions all year, and yet McCown throws a pick here. So you have three turnovers by Texas A&M. That turns into 10 points for Texas Tech, and that's been the difference thus far.
And the numbers tell the story. The Morgan Stanley Dean Witter first half statistics, you look at him only 45 yards on the ground for Texas Tech.
Yeah, and if you look at Texas Tech, Ricky Williams has all 45 of those. Nobody's really gotten going for Texas A&M either. I think the leading rusher is Tomes. He has 34 yards. That's it. Neither quarterback's really gotten off. McCown has two completions and then four completions on the other side for Peters.
Neither team really got in a rhythm in the first half. Texas A&M to kick off. Texas Tech won the initial toss. They deferred to the second half. So we're underway in the second half here in College Station. Norman with a cannon sounding, bringing it back out. And that's where Texas Tech will start the second half. Hi again, everyone. Terry Gannon, Tim Brandt. This, of course, as we told you at the beginning of the ball game, a critical matchup for both teams for control of the Big 12 South.
Yeah, and I think it's because it's that big ball game. I think both teams can feel the pressure and never really got in sync in that first half. I'm really expecting this second half that they really find that rhythm. I think the coaches probably talk to them, settle them down a little bit at halftime, and I think both teams are going to explode here in the second half.
Spike Dykes, the leader up on the sideline for Texas Tech. R.C. Slocum for Texas A&M. Peters the carry on first down drill right at the 30-yard line after a gain of about two. Not much going on at all. Rocky Bernard hit him hard.
hit them hard, and I think both defenses are going to pick up the pace. I think the offenses now are going to get back to what they do best. They got to start running the ball. Neither team really ran effectively in that first half. Both these teams, they really make their bread and butter plays, the running plays, what gets them going. That's their offense. They've got to get back to that.
Ricky Williams, you mentioned 45 yards in the first half. 11-yard touchdown run, too. Here he is out to the 34-yard line. So Williams averaging about 167 yards a game, third leading rusher in the country. Of course, the other Ricky Williams leading the country. Getting some work early on here in the second half. They'll try to establish him early in this second half.
This was his touchdown run in the first half. He got some terrific blocks, especially from Allman, his tight end, and nobody even got a hand on him when he ran that touchdown. I think Sports Illustrated said it best. Never since the I Love Lucy show has Big Ricky and Little Ricky gotten so much national attention.
Third and four, down goes Rob Peters. Ron Edwards, the nose man, number 96, the sophomore out of Houston, wrapped him up and dragged him to the turf. The fifth sack of the afternoon. Peters has not only been hit in the backfield, but hit often at the line of scrimmage on those runs.
This is a guy that really has not been healthy all year either. I mean, he had that sore shoulder. That gave him a problem, the left shoulder. He had the thumb problem. That kept him out for a while, and so Tittle got a lot of playing time. They don't want Peters to get knocked around as much as he's been getting hit in the first half.
Jeremy Hernandez handling the punting duties today. Chris Taylor back deep at his own 27. Taylor up to the 33, follows the football. Aggies get it back, though. Heads up play right at the 32. That was fortunate.
And there again,
Cedric Curry.
There again, Taylor is normally a very sure-handed guy. He's one of their finest receivers. He's a big play player. And yet that one goes right on the ground, and it looks like his wrist or something's bothering him.
He's played well and really come on for this offense at the wideout spot. Yeah, he's holding that right wrist. Had some big plays for R.C. Slocum.
You know, the other thing, we never did see Sir Parker in the lineup at all for A&M in the first half.
We saw six turnovers on the year coming in, but three today. Sir Parker, by the way, has had a hamstring injury. Here's Dante Hall, drives to the left side out to the 32.
Well, he actually had an ankle injury that they thought, okay, that's going to be all right. He's worked through that. He's going to play. But then in warm-ups, then he hurt his hamstring, and he says, hey, I can't go, coach.
So number eight will not be on the field. That really limits what A&M can do offensively. They like to do a lot with Sir Parker, not only at the tailback spot, but putting him in motion, sending him out as a wide receiver. The big fullback tunes with 34 yards. See what Dante has done. McCown on the roll to the right side. Had a man initially, but then tucks it and runs. Gained a yard to the 34. Ty Ardoin, the senior, wrapped him up.
Terry, you're right when you said he had a man initially. It was a play that worked for them in the first half where they took the wide receiver, streaked him down deep to take out the corner, and then brought Taylor, who was in motion, slide him into the flat underneath that the area that the cornerback had just vacated. He was open, but it looked like McCown saw a crease, thought he could take it and pick up some pretty good yardage.
So it's third and eight from the 33. Taylor and Hodge out wide to the near side. Hole to the far side. Dante Hall, the lone setback. Quick drop, looks one way. Monte Rager, guess who? No chance for Randy McCown.
What a fantastic play by Rager, the defensive end. They moved him down inside, working on the big lineman, and he just spun and got past them with quickness. He's going to be in the middle. Stop it right there. Here's 34 right here. Now watch, he'll do a spin move and come in this way. Past the big guys. Look at that spin move right on top of the quarterback. Big time play by Monte Rager.
Loss of five, so it's fourth and 14. The A&M offense went backward that time. Leckler, a line drive kick, going to be fielded at the 31. And up to the 40-yard line, John Norman, who had an interception. A key one in the first half, brings it back 9 yards after the 41-yard punt. And Tech takes over. In the second half, Wrecking Crew and Swarm doing their jobs. Texas Tech takes over. The second drive of the second half for Rob Peters, the junior out of Katy, Texas. Play action, Peters to throw over the middle. It's picked off. picked off at the 26-yard line. Brandon Jennings. Ill-advised throw again from Peters.
Kerry, this is one of the nation's top rushing teams, Texas Tech. One of the biggest offensive lines in the country, college or pro. And yet they are just determined to throw the football. And this time Peters throws into coverage. He never sees the safety. He's watching the corner and the wide receiver, and he never sees the safety come over and make the play. He was under some pressure but had plenty of time to throw. I just can't figure out why, in fact, they just don't start banging it down A&M's throats.
First turnover for Texas Tech was the three that we chronicled in the first half that hurt Texas A&M. And the Aggies take over outside the 25-yard line. They call it the 26. First and 10. McCown, play action, going to throw. Not well thrown either. Aaron Oliver had a step over the middle. So neither quarterback very sharp today.
No, as a matter of fact, McCown's now just 2 for 8. And he's missing one of his big play guys. There's Sir Parker. You mentioned he got hurt in pregame warmups. He's out with a strained hamstring, and of course that hampers him a little bit as well.
Yeah, the hamstring has bothered him for a while now, and he's got such low body fat that any kind of little tweak and any hit here or there.
You're exactly right. He's the fastest guy in A&M's program, and he added muscle weight over the years, but you know, those guys are fragile, those track guys.
Here's Randy McCown up near a first down at the 36-yard line. You believe that one, huh? Monte Rager on the stop.
I believe the part about you being fragile. See, now A&M's ready to start knocking you off the ball, even on pass plays. Now, this is a design run. This is a draw. And they get guys out in front. There's McKinney, 77. Everybody's looking for a white jersey to put a hat on.
Kyle Shipley, the middle linebacker, tagged him first, but Rager came in and drove the whole pile about 3 yards. Shipley even paid when Rager came. Well, it's third and one. Aggies trying to sustain this drive. Toombs hit right at the line of scrimmage and driven backwards. There's a penalty marker on the plate as well. I don't think Toombs got anywhere near the first down.
Terry, the Texas A&M wrecking crew gets so much publicity. They don't talk very much about the swarm defense they have at Texas Tech, but it's got, as we said, that dominator in Rager and the workhorse in Rucker, and Shipley's consistent. This defense is talented.
It's offsides against Texas Tech.
5 yard penalty, first down.
L. Dowden telling us the same, so Spike Stike's defense with a mistake, and they'll move the chains.
Sometimes to make a big play, you got to get that early start.
Got caught. 11th in the nation against the run. And you look at what Rager has done today. Semifinalist for the Lombardi Award, as is Dat Wynn, by the way, and a semifinalist for Butkus Award. Hall in motion. Long count. They give it to Toombs, the fullback. Out to the 43. Nice tackle by Ardwan. That can't be a good prospect and a nice sight coming at you. 262 pounds, and Toombs can run.
You know, and the thing is, he puts fear in both linebackers and defensive backs when you're 265. But these guys know they've got to come up and make a tackle. They're ducking their heads and hitting him low. Guy like that, I think I'm going to hit him high. I'm going to keep my head up. I don't want to get hurt. You want to hit him, and you want to hit him and make sure you bring him down and wrap him up.
Won the state championship as a junior in high school, the shot put championship. Mentioned earlier, he was up about 270 before the season started. They got him a nutritionist. So we got to get down a little bit. Rhodes in motion this time. Here comes Dante Hall straight ahead. Fights his way to the 48, maybe the 49-yard line. Got to get to the 49 of Texas Tech for a first down.
Kyle Shipley with the tackle, his first year as a starter, and he's been very, very consistent. Probably the most consistent player on that swarm defense.
Leads them in tackles.
And the middle linebacker spot in that defensive scheme of Spike Dykes is a leadership role. You look at Zach Thomas preceded Shipley at linebacker, and you look at what he's doing with Miami Dolphins.
Chris Kasura got banged up and had to come out. The defensive tackle, Jones, in there right now. Hits behind Dante Hall. He scrambles and gets there. That pitch was well behind Dante. He had no chance.
He had no chance to make the play. Probably should have eaten it. Watch the pressure coming right off the corner. He doesn't have any pressure or any time to get rid of it right there. He's hit almost immediately by Ardwin, the linebacker. And just no shot.
Lost 13 on the play. So again, Lechter will come on, punt away to John Norman. Low line drive punt. It was touched at the 25, but it was touched by A&M. So it will be down there. A 40-yard punt. Lechler really hasn't booned him like he normally does. Defense is dominating in the second half. In attendance, very strong today. 58,000 plus, of course, not as much in terms of capacity here at Kyle Field because of all the construction in the end zone. They'll have 80,000 starting next year. Texas Tech takes over. You wonder when they're going to start giving the ball to Ricky Williams and saying, win us this game. Right here he goes on first down. Flag on the play as Dat Nguyen wraps him up at the 32.
And it's going to be holding, I believe, against Texas Tech, so they'll bring it back. But, Terry, you're right. They've got to start giving it to Williams and then Williams and then Williams again. They've got to start using that offensive line and the third best rusher in the nation. Watch number 61, Curtis Lowry. It's one of those 330-pound guys. He's number 61. Here he comes right here. Watch number 99 just pull him down, or 46 rather, just pull him down, tackling. See, Anthony never had a chance. He just tackled him.
And tackled him from behind. That's a double whammy. Well, before that play, Ricky Williams had 48 yards, and that was every yard that Texas Tech had on the ground. They back him up. Here he comes again, straight up the middle, a big gain this time. On first down, out to the 32. That's where he was after the first run.
Got to explain to me why they haven't gone to Williams earlier. I mean, here is the third best rusher in the country. You've got this big, strong offensive line that has been successful. I mean, you've got to give it to the guy. Every time he touches it, he makes something positive happen.
And neither quarterback has lit it on fire today. Peters has struggled. So has McCown. Second and three. Williams the lone setback. This time the option. Peters is going to keep it wrapped up behind the line of scrimmage. Sean Corriott, whose brother starred here, the junior out of Sugarland, Texas, on the stop. Well, tomorrow,
the title game.
Williams hit behind the line. Forget about it. A number of Aggie defenders, the wrecking crew defense, led by Ronald Clement, sending him backward.
Third down and short, and Ricky Williams can't get it. He's averaging 166 yards a game, and he only has about 50 yards in this game. They've held him in check because they're not getting any push up front. I mean, look at Haddon, number 50 there. If anything, instead of going forward and driving into the defense, they're pushing him backwards into the ball.
Hernandez, who has split time with Roberson, handling punting duties. Chris Taylor at the 25. Off the side of his foot, this is not a good effort, but it takes a Tech bounce and travels down to the 31. So it ends up better than it should have been. A 36-yard punt from Hernandez. Forget scoring. Offense is not moving the ball at all in the second half. They haul. That one went for 55 yards, but he's trying to get something going in the air.
Yeah, and his leading receiver, Chris Cole, has not even been near the football today.
Bernice Rhodes in motion to the near side. They give it to Tubes, the fullback. Hit once, bounces off ahead to the 38. You get an idea of how strong Jamar Toombs is.
He's not only strong, he's huge.
Jim, these offenses, I know they're going against very good defenses, but they've never really gotten in sync today.
No. On either side, Terry, yeah. You're exactly right. Neither team has really, you know, gotten into that the running game that they wanted. Once the running game goes, then, of course, the passing game comes in with that, and they haven't gotten that.
Taylor in motion on the long count. Give it to Rhodes, wrapped up with the 40, driven back. And a reminder, ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Ford Motor Company. Better ideas driven by you. Sears and the Sears National Champion College Football Trophy. Morgan Stanley, Dean Witter. We measure success one investor at a time. And Chili's, a proud sponsor of ABC College Football. 3:48 and counting in the third quarter. The two fullbacks in there in the backfield, Will Simpson and Jamar Toombs. Out of the shotgun, Randy McCown. They'll blow it dead.
See, Chris Cole down the bottoms. I circled him. He is the guy now that they've got to start looking for on passing downs. He's made a catch in every game this year. He's made big plays when they needed him, and so far he has not touched the ball. They have to start thinking about number 80. This is obviously a passing down from McCown. Unless they run a play off a pass like a quarterback draw or... But right now, you've got to start thinking about Chris Cole. He's not in the ballgame. You've got to get him involved in the ballgame.
It's third down in a long nine, almost 10. There's Cole. Out to the far side. Taylor to the near. He goes in motion. McCown on the run. Throws on the run. Cole comes back, makes the catch, but he doesn't get the first down.
You know, and the reason is he had to come back to make the catch. A good receiver will always come back for the ball. He had gone beyond the sticks. The ball is underthrown. He's got to come back. Now watch him get his push. Now if you look at the top of the screen, you can see there's the first down, but he's got to come all the way back past the first down marker to make that low throw count.
First catch of the afternoon, but it went for 7 yards, almost eight, and they needed nine. Leckler, below his average. Ardoin nearly got a piece of it. And the whistle it dead at the 21 as this stadium has gotten silent all of a sudden. Winning.
Got a feeling it's the lull before the storm, don't you? Now in that last series, Ricky Williams was very frustrated because he didn't get it enough. Now here he comes.
Looking for room, finds some initially, and he made that play into something positive. 25. Out to the 26. Lonnie Madison, the redshirt freshman defensive end, made the stop. There wasn't much room at all for Williams. Comparison between the two Ricky Williams. Tex Ricky, more yards, more carries through the first 18 games of their careers. That's head-to-head in their career, so he has been more productive, at least in terms of the numbers.
And little Ricky averaging 166 yards a game. He had 142 yards rushing last week. And that's the first 18 career games for these two guys. Both outstanding running backs, and certainly has everybody's attention nationally, not only in Texas. I mean, Sports Illustrated did have that great line about, not since the I Love Lucy show has Big Ricky and Little Ricky got such national attention.
Now you got to be very specific when you cast your Heisman vote, that's for sure. He's got 75 yards today. Tech not successful at all on third down. And Williams drives the pile and a late flag. He got enough for the first down before that wind stopped him.
And Terry, that's why it's been such a strange game, because the guys you really think are going to make the plays, the stars, really haven't. Ricky Williams is well below his average right now. That win, we haven't called his name that much. Monte Rager's made some nice plays, but not the kind of game where he's come out and dominated.
Just the defense, 5 yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
Parker and Hall haven't exploded. Parker's not even in the game, and Hall, he got dinged up early, really hadn't gotten all the yardage he normally expects to get.
Cole, one catch on the afternoon just a moment ago.
That's the first time he's gotten involved in the game.
Getting close to that fourth quarter, though, maybe when the stars take over. For the face mask, and they move not only the chains, but the ball up even further. Just outside the 35. Williams with 77 yards on the day. Peters throws into traffic, and it's picked off again. At midfield, again, Rob Peters with an ill-advised throw. Cedric Curry with the interception. And it begs the question, why?
Oh, I can't figure it out. I mean, he throws definitely into coverage. And if you look at his head, he's looking over there the whole time and leading the defenders in that way. So you've got two red shirts around the one white one. Curry makes a good read on the ball, but look, even Dat Wynn is over there. They're all reading the quarterback's eyes, and Peters led him right to the play.
Curry's second interception, actually his third on the year, and Peters has thrown two passes in the second half, and both have been picked off. So inside of midfield, they give it to the fullback, Toombs for for good yardage to the 41. And let's go to New York and check in with John Saunders. John?
Terry, in the Burger King play of the day between UCLA and Cal, and this is just a terrific catch by Brian Pauley-Dixon. Has to leap, come up with the ball, his second touchdown reception of the game from Cade McNown. 21-9, UCLA has the lead. Updating this one, Army giving Notre Dame fits, but it's a final now. The Irish win it 20-17. Terry.
John, it's hard to figure the Irish out. They're winning and they're playing well at times, but not quite sure how good they are. Dante Hall gets away from one and a nice run straight up the middle. So they keep it on the ground, do the Aggies to move the chains. A gain of 7 and 8 seconds left until the fourth quarter.
And because of that, A&M now starting to take charge. We go into the fourth quarter where they've been very successful. They're going to have great field position to start the last part of this game.
It's been all defense in the third. We head to the fourth to decide the Big 12 South lead, at least at this point in the season. We're back after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Mission Control, we have a problem.
Even in today's high-tech engines, deposits can still diminish power.
Dirty fuel system affecting performance.
Enter Valvoline SynPower, a new line of high-performance additives and cleaners. A complete fuel system treatment formulated with component-targeting synthetic molecules that lock on and eliminate those power-robbing deposits.
A fuel and air mixture, a go.
So your engine runs cleaner and performs the way it should.
We have an issue.
Valvoline SynPower, rocket science for the road.
My name is Dennis Porter, and I work in the Ford Dummy Lab. They build it, we crash it. We don't care about the damage, we care about the people.
Our testing exceeds the government standards.
Ford has more 5-star rated vehicles than any other car manufacturer. We go that extra mile to make sure that our cars are safe. I'm proud of that.
Monday, Pittsburgh meets Kansas City. It's not a playoff game, but it might as well be one. Monday at 8 on ABC.
Is justice for sale in Texas? It is for John Cornyn. Cornyn took $500,000 from people with cases before his court. The payoff? Cornyn's court ruled for its big contributors 84% of the time. For insurance, tobacco, polluters, his contributors. Cornyn was so anti-consumer, one ethics group said justice is still for sale in Texas. Cornyn ruled for the same insurance interests he represented as a lawyer. Now they're paying for his attorney general campaign. Is that for sale too?
At last.
Whoa! Oh, oh, this will never do. Whoa!
Introducing the first luxury SUV that doesn't ride like a truck. The Oryx 300, like no other vehicle or value on Earth.
Well, hello there.
At North Park Lexus of San Antonio.
A one-hour special newscast, Survivor Stories at 6 on KSAT 12.
Old Championship Series. Tough day for Rob Peters on the sideline right now, watching his defense, hoping that they can stop Texas A&M. 14-10, the Aggies. And this is what the Tech defense has done this season.
Yeah, they've had problems in the fourth quarter. I mean, you see what they've done in the first three quarters and then what they've given up in the last quarter. And here we go now, starting the last 15, and A&M's got terrific field position.
So the Aggies first and 10 at the 35. Dante Hall, the first carry of this drive, and down to the 27-yard line. Terry Gannon, Tim Brandt opening up the fourth quarter here in College Station.
And three straight runs now, 18 yards for A&M. And it looks like they're just going to try to just keep banging it down there and hammering it home. Look at the drive that the offensive line gets. They get some blocking up front. They open up that. Even your tight end Spillers out there, or Campbell, rather, gets that block in the corner, and Campbell drives him off. You're going to see more and more of that at A&M.
Double tight end set now on second and two. Toomes and Hall out of the eye. Dante gets the call. so elusive. Gets ahead, should have the first down. He's very near that marker, at least.
I think he's going to be a little bit short, but I think the Texas A&M coaches have said, hey, listen, we've got great field position. Let's do what we do best. Let's play smash-mouth football. The rules of the game now for the fourth quarter, straight ahead, no fair dodging.
Brings up third and one. You got to look at Hall and how quick he hits the hole, but also can sidestep in, get away from the tackler. Never get a real good shot at him. 54 yards on the ground. Neither he nor Ricky Williams have put up the numbers that they have been accustomed to.
Derek Spiller comes into the ballgame now. Jumbo formation. Everybody tight.
Toombs, jumbo back ahead for the first down. No surprise, nothing tricky.
Steve Craigthorpe now is saying, hey, look, guys, we're going big. We're banging the ball. Now we'll get our splits here on first down, and we'll try to get Hall free. That's not to say they aren't going to pass, because there's a response also from the Texas Tech defense. They're starting to feel this run. They're starting to feel that the offensive line of A&M starting to take over. So eventually, Craigthorpe's going to feel like, all right, we've got an opportunity now to throw. In other words, he's going to break his tendencies. He's playing a chess game right now. So far on this drive, it's working.
And this is an offense that's been less conservative the past couple of weeks. Hall trying to turn the corner. Outside, nowhere to go. At the 23, run out of bounds is Dante. Devin Lemons, the sophomore, made the hit.
A&M now starting to build up their statistics rushing wise.
Last 10 meetings, A&M 270 yards.
Here's your guy now. See, now he got his first catch in the last series. Now you got second down and long. You've been going to Hall. Don't forget about Cole.
Here's Hall again, though. They give it to him again. He bounces away from one. Slips inside the 15 to the 13-yard line. Ty Arjuan wrapped him up, saved the touchdown.
Down close to another first down, about a yard short. So it'll be third down and short. Now go to Jumbo again. But look at the offensive line. Look at the hole they're opening up. Look at the block by the big you had Campbell get a block. Spiller got a block. Hodge got a block. 88. All doing an outstanding job on this drive to end the third quarter and start the fourth here.
Three tight ends in again in the jumbo set. This time they give it to Dante. Hit right at the line. Fell ahead. We'll have to wait and see. Kevin McCullough, the outside linebacker, got there quickly.
I think he got it. It's going to be close. But the change they made in the jumbo package that time was putting Hall at the tailback spot rather than Toomer. I mean, Toombs, who's 265.
Battle on the ground going to A&M today, but the turnovers early in the game hurt them. Neither team able to score in the third quarter.
You know, the problem is Toombs loves to get the ball. He loves to run for the ball and get the first. But if he has a problem, it's blocking. And look, he doesn't give Hall much help on this one. As a matter of fact, he doesn't even touch a white jersey. He makes the block. He makes the cutoff block there, even if he just gets in the way, and Hall would have gotten the first.
It's fourth and one. The crowd likes the decision to go for it, but really there's not much of a decision to be made for R.C. Slocum. A field goal doesn't really help him all that much. Tech could still, with a touchdown, tie it or go ahead. And they failed to reset the play clock, so they'll take some time to do that right now.
R.C. Slocum in the past, very successful, and again this year on fourth down conversions. And when he gets this close, a lot of times he doesn't like to risk a handoff. He'll have his quarterback sneak it if he finds a crease. I mean, this is just a lean forward type play. This is, you get Hamouli and McKinney and Spikes just to drive off that line, and McCown just finds a crease.
10 of 11 on fourth down coming into the game. They're one for one today, though. You remember the fake field goal and the touchdown catch made by Dan Campbell.
Of course, if you don't want McCown to carry it, I'd go back to that jumbo package and put Toombs in there.
Hey, you give it to Jamar Toombs, you're not going to go wrong.
No, how do you stop him for a half foot?
Don't forget, at the conclusion of today's game, we'll select the Chevrolet Most Valuable Player of the Game for each team. In recognition of these athletes, Chevrolet will make a contribution to each school's general scholarship fund.
Great scene for college football here. College Station people jammed in. They love their football all over the country, the Aggie Club. As a matter of fact, all the way out in Washington, D.C. in the Grand Hyatt today. Got hundreds of Aggie games.
Now, on the other sideline, though, for Texas Tech, our Home Depot coaches back, Spike Dykes, longest tenure, and R.C. Slocum, 10 years in the Big 12. So two guys who have been around a long time, and they have been friends a long time, too. Fourth and one. Toombs, Rhodes in the backfield. Jumbo set with three tight ends. The count to keep it, he gets it. First down, Aggies.
R.C. Slocum likes to do that, and the reason he does not like to risk a handoff in such short yardage. Just let your offensive line do the job, and McCown goes ahead and picks out his little crease. Now watch, he'll actually take a step to read where the crease is. See it? He reads it to the right. There's the crease. There's the yard. There's the first.
10th play of the drive now for A&M. It's the first one that they've been able to sustain in the second half. First one that either team really has been able to sustain for any length of time. Option to the near. McCown to keep it. After one, he goes down hard.
Boy, he
swarmed
was
under.
He was tagged. You're right, Terry. He went down hard. He never saw a linebacker coming over, and they went helmet to helmet. Also looked like Cody Patton has his hat in on a play. Watch this now. He'll come down this way towards you, and then the pressure comes from inside. As soon as he makes that cut inside, boom. Helmet to helmet contact.
That was Kevin McCullough came in and popped it. Dante Hall deep in the eye on second and 10. Kept it on the ground throughout this entire drive. Hall inside the 10 to the 9. Norman and Chris Kasurik, who was banged up earlier in the game, came back in to make the hit. Derek, a great talent. They love him. At 32 tackles as a freshman a year ago. Only a sophomore.
All right, so you've gone Hall most of this drive. Of course, again, you got to think about Cole. It's second down. Long. You've got to think this is your big play guy, your leading receiver.
The two fullbacks, they split from McCown out of the shotgun on third down. Quarterback draw up the middle, not going to make it. Drives down inside the 7 to the 6-yard line. Got more than he should have initially. He was hit by Keith Cochran right away. And Kasurik again.
Well, they split him wide, tried to create some air, but, you know, they leave guys unaccounted for. Rager comes through clean. He's the one that slowed him up and let pursuit take him down finally. All right, so the defense holds. The swarm makes it stop, keep him to a field goal attempt. But, of course, this is where they got their touchdown. You've got to be conscious of the fake.
And Leckler threw to Campbell on the fake early in the game. Down, up this time, and inside that right upright. Not by much. A 24-yarder for Russell Bynum. Still a touchdown away, though. It's 17-10, Aggies over Tech.
Introducing the all-new Grand Am GT. Its solid form design provides a stronger body structure so you can have the ride of your life with fewer vibrations. Excitement, well built. The all-new Grand Am GT by Pontiac.
May I help you?
If I wanted a Whopper, no pickles, that wouldn't be a problem. But would we get to hear you sing?
No, sir. You get to hear us sing.
Hold the pickle, hold the lettuce, special orders, don't go.
May I help you?
If I want my value meal with rings instead of fries, is that a problem?
Value meal with rings or fries, it still costs a great price. You don't have to ask us twice to have it your way.
When you have it your way, it just tastes better.
Ooh.
be playing with your mama tonight.
Adam Sandler, The Water Boy, PG-13, starts Friday, November 6th.
DC United, Chicago Fire, it's MLS Cup 98, the biggest game of the year, live Sunday at 3:30 Eastern on ABC.
An important stop by Texas Tech. They forced the field goal, so it's 17-10. A&M in the lead, 9:47 left in this one in College Station. John Norman comes up to his seven and drops the football. Got it back. Reverses. Cuts back across the 20. There's a penalty marker back at the 15 as Norman brings it out to the 24-yard line.
Terry, you say that's a huge stop by Texas Tech, and it really is. It keeps the Red Raiders within a touchdown, and we have just made the point that that's where they give up all their points in the fourth quarter. Huge, huge stop.
No backup Tech because of the penalty. Ricky Williams, it's now up to him on the last drive by A&M. They stayed on the ground with Dante Hall until the end of the drive.
And it was that defensive unit that made that stop that ran over. As they're coming onto the field, they all went over to Williams. They were patting him on the butt, patting him on the helmet. I mean, almost to say, hey, we did our job. Now take over, Ricky. Let's go to work.
But he's got to start inside the 10, just outside the 7-yard line. First and 10 as Rob Peters comes on to the football field.
And that kind of field position certainly limits what you can do, especially when your quarterback's been struggling throwing.
Only 48 yards in the air, a couple interceptions for Peters in this second half. Williams straight ahead, he dropped the football. Peters may have gotten it back. A&M saying they have it, but it looked like Rob Peters, the quarterback, got to the ball.
He did. It is going to be Tech ball, but it moves him back to the 5-yard line, so they lose yardage on the play with the fumble. Boy, Ricky Williams just got stuck.
Mike's going to wear out that sideline facing back and forth.
This whole stadium's rocking. You can feel it here in the booth. The booth is moving.
Well, sways half the time, and right now it's jumping up and down. De Jackson in motion, but Peters rolling to the near side. Hits his tight end over the middle, who is just popped at the 16. Kyle Alleman hung on after Rich Cody leveled him.
That's Allman's 7th catch of the year. Tight ends don't make many catches in this offense. They've averaged 9 catches over the last 3 years by that position. But this is huge. He didn't make the catch, but then he hangs on when he was decked. Very difficult to do.
Didn't get the first down, though. He's a little more than a yard, almost 2 shy of the marker. So a key third down with just over 8 minutes left in the game. Ricky Williams, he's got a first down across the 25 to the 26. Jennings brought him down, but they will move the chains this time.
His feet are so quick. Williams moves it, and they barely touch the ground. It's almost like tap dancing on a light bulb. Watch how fast he gets through this hole. And look at his feet. Like little pistons.
Hits the hole so quick. 8-yard gain.
He's better this year. I mean, he's better, and his style has changed. He's much more patient as a runner, and he sees his blocks better.
And stronger. Williams, though, this time behind the line of scrimmage. Rocky Bernard stood him up. Now more college football action. Great season continuing next week. Regional action at 3:30. Texas against number 7 Nebraska in this region. And Ohio State takes on Indiana, Washington, USC, an ACC game, too. Check your local listings and check with your cable operator, your satellite company, for those available on pay-per-view next Saturday. Second and 10, they haven't taken their seats yet here at Kyle Field in the last drive. Quick out, Donnie Hart, who's been quiet today with the catch. His first catch of the afternoon. 2 yards short of a first down as Jason Webster knocks him out.
Now Hart take his cut before he got to the sticks, and I'm sure the coaches are going to tell him that as he goes back to the sideline. But it was a good catch. He threw in rhythm that time for the first time. Peters looked like he was in control, put some velocity on the ball, and it was a 3-step drop through on schedule.
You know this offense isn't clicking if Donnie Hart, who came in with 31 catches on the year, has only one catch now in the fourth quarter. Give it to the up back I don't know if he got there. Michael Wilborn, the fullback, it looks like he's short of a first down. Got to the 35.
And he does not get a friendly mark, so he is going to be short of the first. And you almost certainly have to punt this ball away at this stage in the game.
That win made the stop. Another one of the stars whose name we haven't called off.
Spike doesn't like the mark. He thought he had the first down. He's not happy. He's telling the official about it.
It's gamble time. Fourth and one. Spike Dykes going to go for it.
6.5 minutes to go, and he is going for it.
Wilborn, the fullback, in there along with Ricky Williams out of the eye. They give it back to Williams, and I think Wilborn was in motion illegally. They throw the flag before they get the snap off. And there's no decision now.
No, and Spike Dykes, I think, got a break there. He got a break there because A&M was all over this play with or without the illegal motion. There's the movement, and the flag comes out immediately. But if you look at A&M, they had great containment on the outside. They had a lot of pursuit coming, and I'm not sure that play would have worked anyway.
On the offense, 5-yard penalty, still fourth down.
So with that penalty, Spike Dykes now gets another chance to punt it out of there.
Didn't like the way it ended up, but it may have been a break, as you say. How about the decision to pitch it back 5 yards to Ricky Williams on fourth and one? Hernandez got 40 yards on the average. Chris Taylor, as this stadium falls silent at the 22. 48 yards on the punt. Texas A&M try to use the clock now. 6:06 left.
America Online introduces new version 4.0.
There has never been a better time to get online.
The easiest just got easier.
Instant messages.
I can customize my email.
My niece sent me a picture.
If you have a phone line, you can be online.
It's the easiest way to keep up with old friends.
Everyone I know is on it.
We've spent over $1 billion to create a high-speed network. And with 56K, connections are faster than ever.
It's the ultimate local guide.
New 4.0, check it out.
It's my connection to the world.
America Online. So easy to use, no wonder it's number one. Sign up today.
Because there is a man in Chicago planning his retirement this year. Because there is a family in Boston who hopes to send their kids to college someday. Because there is a doctor in New York looking forward to the day she will open her own clinic. Because the dreams of every investor continue to change in a complex world, so too have we. Which is why at Morgan Stanley Dean Witter, we measure success one investor at a time.
If you've been thinking about jumping into a rugged new Montana,
I need more room!
Now's a really good time.
Never seen a minivan do that before.
Maybe it's not really a minivan.
Life was more exciting in Montana. Now jump into a rugged Montana with this limited time offer, but get a move on because the train's leaving the station. See your Pontiac dealer today.
Both defenses earning their nicknames today. The Wrecking Crew with a fourth down stop, forcing the punt. That win with a big play within that series. And now it's up to Dante Hall to try to keep it on the ground. 22 rushes for 66 yards. They'd love to give it to him and milk this clock. Here he comes to the near side. And away from one. And up to the 23-yard line.
Thursday afternoon when we were talking to R.C. Slocum at practice, he was talking about clock management, and he was talking about against Nebraska specifically, but he says anytime you get down into the last 7 minutes of the game, you do want to shorten the game when you have the lead. You want to melt the clock and eliminate any chance that they can have to score quickly. And so that's what he's going to do now. He's going to try to move this. Although on first down there, he only got a yard, so that'll change the thinking just a little bit.
Yeah, you can't get too conservative right now. You need a couple of first downs. McCown wrapped up at the 17. He went down Reagan bounds.
That changed your thought a lot.
Yes. Another reminder, ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by the all-new Grand Am with solid form design. It's excitement well built. From Pontiac. Marriott Hotels, Resorts, and Suites. We believe when you're comfortable, you can do anything. America Online, so easy to use, no wonder it's number one. And Valvoline. You can always tell the guys who use Valvoline. A loss of six as Bounds got to McCown that time. Leroy Hodge in motion. on a key third down. Play action for McCowney's hit as he throws. Got Cole over the middle. He overthrows him.
Boy, that's great coverage out there by Brown, though. Brown was all over him. He had Cole right from the beginning, and again, he just looked at him and followed him across and led Brown, the cornerback, right to the pass. Nicely done right there by Brown. Darwin Brown, best cover guy they have.
A lot of pressure on McCown, too. Ty Arduan was in the backfield right away. Leckler will punt it away to John Norman, who's back at the 40. Set up the return this time. No pressure, and look at this. Booms this one back inside the 30. Norman back out to the 35. The first punt today that we have seen from Shane Leckler that looks like a Leckler punt. There's a flag on the play, by the way. They'll back him up even further. 54 yards on the punt, a 6-yard return. RC's defense after a key stop on the last series on fourth down trying to do the same. Dante getting a rest.
Introducing the all-new Grand Am GT. Its solid form design provides a stronger body structure so you can have the ride of your life with fewer vibrations, excitement, well built. The all-new Grand Am GT by Pontiac.
Afraid your next get-together will be a flop? Order Chili's Party Platters. Act now, call a Chili's representative, and your guests will flip over party-sized servings of buffalo wings, baby back ribs, and more. End pre-party stress now. Order Chili's Party Platters, new from Chili's.
Hi, I'm expecting a fax.
Room 212 wants the ammunition to deal with her toughest clients.
Nothing. Hi. Davies 212. I called earlier.
Right, fax. Yes. That hasn't come yet.
I need it for a meeting.
Excuse me, Miss Davies? Oh, just came in.
Thank you so much. Good morning, everyone.
Business Services by Marriott. When you're comfortable, you can do anything.
Sunday, their love thrives. Even though they're both deaf and blind, Barbara Walters with the most incredible couple you'll ever meet. Watch 2020 Sunday at 9, 8 Central.
It looked like Tech was going to get great field position, and number 29, Ty Arduan's called for the block in the back. Watch this. Here comes your guy, Dat Wynn, right here. Now watch, here's the block in the back on Wynn. It's almost just a push from behind. Boom! The flag comes out, and instead of having great field position up by midfield, they move it back with a penalty. Yeah, he's not happy.
Dat never saw him coming. Here's the throw. Hasn't been successful at all in the second half. Donnie Hart comes back to make the catch. Holy cow! It looked like he was out of bounds, and obviously you can't go out and come back in, but he makes the catch, and they'll rule it complete at the 48.
R.C. Slocum came over and talked to the officials about it, too, but you won't see a better catch than that one. Watch this. Over top of the defender, over top of the defensive back, and he makes the play. That is phenomenal. I don't think Curry even saw the ball. Certainly didn't see the receiver coming over his head to make the catch. But Hart with a huge play. And then when Peters threw it, of course, he paid the price. Watch this. Boom. And he fields it from Bradley, number 40.
What a play. A 27-yard gain. Ricky Williams goes down at the line of scrimmage. In fact, he may have lost one.
Hart's catch was as good as you will ever see in college football.
Over the top of Curry, who never saw the ball.
That's the old Lynn Swann technique.
Yeah, Ricky lost one on first down, so it's second and 11. Hart's been quiet all day. It's only his second catch, but he's averaging about 23 yards a catch on the year. That one for 27.
And time certainly now becomes a factor in this ball game.
Second down, play action, throwing back to the fullback. Hawkins, who's got room, got a block. inside the 35 to the 33. They'll move the chains again for Texas Tech on the move now.
Well designed. Take your All-American Ricky Williams. Send him one way. Linebackers follow him. Then throw back to the fullback on the backside. Watch this. All right, there's the play action to Williams. The linebackers go that way. Now you come back to your big guy, and you set up the screen. Get a couple of the big blockers in front of him. And Lowry was out there. Hawkins threw a good block.
Hawkins, a good receiver out of the backfield at 226 pounds and a sophomore from Wichita Falls, Texas. First down now, inside the 35. Ricky Williams cuts back against the grain, tripped up. Nice tackle by Dat Wynn. Got down to the 26. He barely got him by a shoestring. With a gain of 8.
Lowry and Haddon again with good blocks, but you will not get better than Dat Wynn. He may have saved the touchdown here. Look at him run to the football, and he's the last line of defense because things are wide open and there are blockers out in front of him. Great tackle by Dat Wynn.
But a gain of 8, so 2nd and 2 now. Do you take a shot long here or keep it on the ground and get the first down?
I'd go back to Williams. I'd get him the ball in some fashion.
Yeah, they're going to throw. Going to go towards the end zone. Donnie Hart, nowhere near him.
Coach Gannon all over it.
Yeah, but now it's been no easy money getting 2 yards on 3rd down. Sunday night, ESPN live at 8:15 Eastern. Doug Flutie and the Bills take on Carolina. And then Monday night football, we see the Steelers and the Chiefs at Arrowhead, 8 o'clock Eastern time. Monday night.
Terry, I knew what you were saying, and you're right. 2nd down, waist down, you can always come back on 3rd and get it. But the passing game has been so bad today, I'm surprised they don't just stick with this.
Ricky straight ahead trying to pick up the 1st down. And he'll be close. Looks like it should be if he gets a good mark.
You know what I'm saying? On 4th down in their offensive series, they didn't get it. So I was thinking, give Ricky Williams 2 times to try to get it. Because, to be honest, Peter's passing game has not been there as we saw just a second ago.
And I think there have been times throughout the day when both clubs have gone away from their strength, their running backs.
But, I mean, you're right. Ordinarily on 2nd down, and sure, you would go and take your shot. And they did, but didn't get it.
Williams picked up the 1st down now. A little over 2 minutes left in the game. Option to the near side. Penalty markers. They're going to whistle it dead. Fullback in motion again. That's where they got the penalty on 4th down on the last drive.
Dead ball. Ball start. On the offense. 5-yard penalty. Still 1st down.
Actually, it looked like your end move, too, a little bit early. See if there isn't some movement right down here. There he is. Yep. See, that cost him again. Now they move it back.
9th penalty of the day for Spike Dyke's team.
And approaching the 2-minute point in this game. You know, this game is hard enough. You don't want to make it more difficult. Now 1st and 10, it's 1st and 15.
Especially against a defense like A&M. He used to throw on 1st, got the fullback Hawkins drilled. Curry knocked him out at the 25.
And Terry, he does not even get back to the original line of scrimmage. So it's going to take him at least 2 plays to get over that penalty.
But the clock does stop. Each team with 3 timeouts, don't forget. The Thrifty Carolina postgame report after the game. John Saunders, Todd Blackledge from New York. Time permitting, and time should permit. 2nd and 12 now. Peters to the line, quick count. Under pressure, he's going to go down. He got the ball off and out of bounds. They're going to rule it incomplete. Cornelius Anthony on the blitz.
Peters is shaken up a little bit, too. He feels the hit from Anthony. But again, they brought the blitz. They brought it inside. Watch 46. Left of your screen, untouched again. Keep in mind now, Rob Peters had a bad left shoulder coming into this ball game. Now it's better. He also had that thumb earlier in the season, but I think that shoulder just felt that hit by Anthony.
So Texas Tech burns a timeout. They've got 2 left and a key 3rd down coming up when we return. 12 at the 25 for Texas Tech. The money players come up big at this point in the game.
Dat Wynn is certainly the money player on defense, and here's your guy you're looking for right now, Hart, the wide receiver.
3rd down, Peters to throw. going to go up top to Hart. Fights. Comes back incomplete.
Oh, no. They said he was out of bounds. I thought he was in. That was another great catch. Oh, my. Hart's the guy you want to go to in that situation. I thought his feet were in. Take a look at it yourself. The ball is well thrown, and it's another one of those acrobatic catches. Here he's got the step. He goes back and makes the catch. Nope. Good
he
call.
Was out.
Good call.
And he may have been out before that anyway.
Yes, he is. Yes, he was. Good call on the play. See, but how he brings his feet back in? After he made the catch, I looked to see first if he made the catch, then I looked at his feet, and he did slide him back in. That's like a catcher. After he makes the catch, slides his mitt over into the strike zone.
Trying to frame that pitch, and that's what Donnie Hart was trying to do. Well, now
he fooled me.
It is four down territory. Texas Tech going to call the timeout. They've got fourth and 12, still at the 25, and they've got to get to the 13-yard line. One timeout remaining. We're back after this message to College Station. Donnie Hart with the catch, but he was out of bounds.
Spike Dykes and the Red Raiders have won the last three games in this series against the A&M Aggies, and Detwin and those guys don't want to go out of here in their last year thinking we lost four in a row
for control of the Big 12 South Division. Tech on fourth down. Very good. Peters the straight drop going to the end zone. One-on-one in the back end of the end zone. Incomplete. Through the hands and out. Derek Doris had a shot, but good coverage by Jason Webster. One timeout left for Texas Tech. A full load for the Aggies.
You know, he had him. I don't think everybody realizes how close this was to being a touchdown. But Doris, watch this. He's inbounds, gets a hand on it, and almost pulls it in. Good coverage on the play by Webster, but almost a great catch by Doris. Got that one hand up on it and almost made the grab. Oh, man.
Would have been a great catch, but you're right. He had a chance to make it.
Oh, there's no question it would have been a great catch, but it was going to take a great catch to win.
Only one timeout now for Texas Tech. Dante Hall keeps it on the ground. They'll try to strip him with a football. And something that Spike Dykes' club does very well.
So they'll immediately call the one timeout. That'll stop the clock with 1:26. Then they'll try to make two more quick stops and see if they can get the ball back one more time. But I think Spike feels it too. That last one, that was the shot to win it.
Now, and Spike said coming into the game, if they lose one more in the Big 12, they're out of the South race. You've got Texas on the schedule for both clubs still to come. But Texas A&M would move to 4-0. And have full control. Texas, of course, with one loss at this point.
That's all their timeouts, right?
That's right, Coach.
Yeah, that's all their timeouts. Yeah.
.126 left. The Chevrolet most valuable players of the game. Ty Ardoin from Texas Tech, Cornelius Anthony from Texas A&M. The defense is really dominating in this game. Ardoin with 12 tackles, Anthony 9 tackles and a sack. A Chevrolet donation will be made to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and to assist those in financial need. It's been a Chevrolet tradition for more than a quarter of a century. Second down with a minute 26 left. Give it to Dante Hall. Tripped up in the backfield. But Texas Tech without a timeout to stop the clock.
Now you want to help everybody up, get them back, walk it back so the official now can reset the clock. A&M, of course, wants to take its time. Absolutely no hurry now. You can see the clock up left hand of your corner as we approach one minute.
.51 in counting. Randy McCown, who has brought the intangibles. to the quarterback position for A&M. Hall bounces off a one, scrambles to the 25, clutching the football very tightly. 33 and counting now. And Ricky Williams, not the kind of day that he's used to, just under 100 yards.
Been a strange day, though.
Really has.
Neither team really got going. And I think both coaches know that. It's like a golfer, you know, when the game's just not there and you have to keep grinding through the bad times. That's what these coaches were doing. They were grinding today. That's a big win for A&M.
Now, R.C. Spalding's club now going to move to 4-0 in the Big 12 as they call the timeout right now.
No. That's too much time, delay of game with 1 second left, so...
They called the timeout.
Oh, did they get it in time? Because, look, there's a flag up at the 40.
Now, the official on the near side gave the timeout to RC, and there's a flag at the 41.
There is the flag that's down. One guy was looking at the clock and went to throw that flag. Let's see if he picks it up, see if they got the timeout.
We'll see which official.
He's marking a timeout down on his sheet, so he's saying they got the timeout in time. And now the other official's got to go over and say, hey, coach, I had the flag down, but... Guy's putting his flag away, talking to Spike Dyke, saying, look, the coaches are all upset.
Now the Texas Tech going to drop to 6-2, 3-2 in the Big 12, and probably is what Spike Dyke said, out of the race in the Big 12. And the A&M Aggies well on their way to playing in that Big 12 championship game.
One last chance for Texas Tech. And that's going to be just watching the quarterback take a knee. That's it. So it's a chance, but it's not really.
And now there's no chance. The Aggies with the win. Spike Dyke's club came in, played well defensively, never really got it going offensively, though, as they have in the last couple of weeks. And R.C. Slocum gets the win over one of his best friends in college football, two Texas guys who have been close for a long time. 17-10, Texas A&M, a winner today in College Station over Texas Tech.
R.C. Slocum doesn't care how ugly it was. He's glad to have the win.
With Tim Brandt, I'm Terry Gannon. The trick play early on and the fake field goal, a big one after the turnovers. And A&M victorious at home. They continue to roll in the Big 12. So long, everybody.
All right, guys, coming up, we'll have scores and highlights on the Thrifty Car Rental postgame report. If you're R.C. Slocum, it's a couple of weeks removed, but you don't want to have a letdown at any point in a season where you knock off someone like Nebraska.
Yeah, and this is a team, Texas Tech, that A&M's had troubles with. Two teams like to play the same way, run the football, play hard defense.